Every year, one thing is always predictable. Postage costs go up. Stamps.com gives you crazy discounts of up to 89% off USPS and UPS services, so your business will barely notice the change. Stamps.com has been indispensable for over 1 million businesses just like yours. It's like your own personal post office. No lines, no traffic, no waiting. Sign up with promo code PROGRAM for a 4-week trial, plus free postage and a free digital scale. No long-term commitments or contracts. That's Stamps.com code PROGRAM.
What's up? It's your boy, The Ted Smith from The Men's Room. And did you know I have a podcast? Well, I do. The Podcast. New episodes uploaded every Wednesday on the Odyssey app.
Unfortunately, what you're about to hear is real. The members of this radio program are simply not that bright, or what some people would call educated. They are merely stupid. They're not trying to offend anyone on purpose. And all have played doctors on TV. You have been warned and are cordially invited to join the party. This is the Men's Room.
Forget it, man, and get with the countdown. Get with the countdown. Shake this square world and blast off for Kicksville. The trippers, the grasshoppers, the hip ones, all gathered in secrecy and flying high as a kite.
This is the Men's Room with Miles and Thrill. You know what they say, shake your radio more than three times, and you're playing with it. You're listening to the Men's Room.
And away we go. Welcome to season 19, episode number 4036. Along with Steve the Thrill Hill, D. Ted Smith, and my car.
Montgomery!
And you, Wired Men's Row. On tap today, Taryn Daly and Steve Miggs from the Daily Miggs Morning Show. Join us once again. We will sit and spin. And today, believe it or not, shockingly enough, we do a dry January.
Yeah.
With 10 songs about sobriety. We will play Profile This, plus headlines, the Men's Room Shot of the Day, fun with listener emails, and everyone's favorite, TV Time with Ted.
Clack, clack.
Drinking the drunk.
All right, here we go. Woman who is a huge hockey fan found with 65 stolen Stanley Cups in her car. To Florida, where a 20-year-old with a Camaro. He wants to one day be a NASCAR star. Man causes flight delay because he thought that a first-class ticket gets you an extra seat for free.
Jesus.
Police find drug suspect hiding in home. Good news, he was dry as can be. And cops ask a man for his ID, so he accidentally hands him his meth. That is all coming on today's very special episode of The Men's Room.
And now, here's the question.
Hola, bitches. Good day to you and yours. All right, actor Jamie Dornan, a.k.a. the guy from 50 Shades of Grey, he's a healthy 41-year-old man, but last year he went to the hospital with all the telltale signs of a heart attack. The good news, he was not having a heart attack. The bad news is that he still had all the painful symptoms as a direct result of coming into contact with a pine processionary moth caterpillar, which have poisonous hairs all over their bodies. Now, these particular caterpillars, they're mostly in Europe and Northern Africa, so we don't need to worry about them so much here in the States. No, instead, we get things like bed bugs. In fact, our friends at Orkin, they just posted their 2024 list of top cities for bed bugs, and for the fourth year in a row, Chicago takes home the trophy for the bed buggiest. But don't worry, Chicago, you're going to forget all about these bed bugs in just a few months, because you see where you're located. You'll be right at the epicenter this April when not one, but two cicada broods emerge at the same time for the first time in 221 years. It happens every 221 years. Ted, you're giving me that look. You know cicadas well.
Here's
the thing. Cicadas, they're harmless, but they're expecting about 1 trillion of them between the two broods. And keep in mind, they are very loud and they're very stupid, much like that one kid that you went to school with. But we're not here to talk about kids. No, today we're talking bugs. Now, sure, there's poisonous caterpillars, there's bed bugs, there's cicadas, but how about Sephora spiders? They're not actually Sephora spiders, they're wolf spiders, but it turns out that Sephora customers who've purchased their Sol de Janeiro body butter, they discovered that the spiders They are hopelessly attracted to it. Some kind of pheromone in the product, to the point that one person actually had a spider chase her. That's her bug story. But we want to hear your bug story, because there's trillions of them on this planet. And whether you like them or not, you got to interact. So today, we want to know, what is your personal story involving a bug's life?
To be a part of the Big Show, call 206-803-ROCK. You can like the Men's Room on Facebook, follow us on Twitter and Instagram at Men's Room Live, and send those emails to themensroom at KISW.com.
The debauchery rolls on. You're listening to the Men's Room with Miles and Thrill. 99.9 KISW.
Home and toes, away we go. Welcome to Season 19, Episode number 4036. What a large and a charged program we have for you today. Guaranteed future repeat. Taryn Daly and Steve Miggs from the Daily Miggs Morning Show will join us once again. We'll sit and spin. Some of you out there may be participating in what they call a dry January.
No.
That's where it doesn't rain in Seattle for an entire month.
That would be cool.
I'd take that dry January in a heartbeat. That would be amazing.
That's not realistic.
No, it's not. We're talking about dry January. We don't drink for a month. So, in honor of dry January, and those who are attempting to celebrate the best you can.
Is that a celebration? Are you celebrating dry January if you're actively doing a dry January?
You do things that you have not done in a long time.
You mean what, to occupy your time? Like, spring cleaning?
When's the last time you had sex and you were sober other than the morning?
Sober sex.
See?
Man, oh man.
It's at night. You go to bed.
You said other than the morning. So I'm like, you wake up in the morning. Yeah, it was the morning. Yeah, it was morning. Yeah. Boy, it was good, too.
Right? But still, I mean, think about that. Just basic things that you typically do. Maybe you just enjoy sitting down, watching some television, having a cocktail.
But you're still going to get laid when you're sober. You know what I mean?
I don't know.
Because when you're both a little tipsy, it's like, oh, yeah, let's do this. But I've never seen my wife sober. I'm drunk. And she's like, please bring your drunk ass over here and hop in bed with me right now. Mm-hmm. That's what I want.
Well, it's only you doing the dry January, so I think you're still in business.
Fine point.
So
last time I did one, that's what helped. She wasn't dry.
So you I feel like dudes definitely take, I'm horny. Awesome.
The idea of brunch goes out the window. Yes, you can go get breakfast, but you are not going to go get brunch. Because
it's all Bloody
brunch
Marys, mimosas.
Breakfast with cocktails. That's what brunch
is. That is basically what it is.
You go get breakfast, but you can't eat brunch. There's all kinds of weird things that probably would play into, thank God the Super Bowl, I guess, is in February. That helps a little bit.
That's probably why they moved it to the...
But that's one of the hardest things, I think, is just starting the first day of the year out. With all the college football on, it's a national holiday. A lot of people have get-togethers, barbecues. You know, you cook, you hang out.
I mean, look, typically, I've said this before.
A great day to sit around and basically do what you do on Thanksgiving, but with college football instead of pro football.
Like, if that's what you want to do, do it. I don't think it's important to start on the first day of the year for multiple reasons, but if you do enjoy sports, I would say you can still get about 4 good weeks in between the Super Bowl and March Madness really taking off.
It stacks the deck on your New Year's resolution. Maybe you do want to get back to the gym. That maybe would help something like that. But than your, you know, your physical fitness or maybe trying to eat better or whatever, that's a lot to put on your plate for the first day of the year.
Yeah, that's why I don't do that.
But either way,
straight up, man.
People held it off.
The few times I've done it, it does help, like Super Bowl. Oh, we're going to eat and get hammered.
Oh, absolutely.
And when it comes to music, as far as songs go, very rarely are there songs about drinking that aren't upbeat, whether it's tequila or whether Margaritaville or whatever it is. They're always happy songs for the most part, gin and juice.
Sure.
Sobriety songs, not so much. They are, when people sing about drinking, they typically have a happy beat. They never have a line about waking up in a gutter. Or,
and if they do, they're still puking Riley.
Mm-hmm. Or accidentally throwing up in someone's living room at a party. None of that's ever brought up. It's always just about having a good time. So today we have 10 songs about sobriety coming up as we will sit and spin. And lucky you get more Men's Room every Monday through Friday exclusively on Odyssey. And the Odyssey app. Join us for the Men's Room Happy Hour in episode number 528. We didn't get to get into our picks done last night, so we'll do that tonight. Also make the picks for the weekend. Just get that out of the way on the two playoff games as you got your Baltimore Ravens and Kansas City Chiefs. And then, of course, San Francisco taking on the Detroit Lions.
Right.
And the later game. Both those games this weekend coming on Sunday. So we'll do picks for episode number 528. If you don't have the Men's Room Happy Hour or the Odyssey app, download that Odyssey app. Search for the Men's Room. You'll see the Men's Room Happy Hour channel. Right now, that's 24 hours of nothing but our best shows. So it's a 24-hour channel of nothing but Men's Room. Then we break in at 6 for the Men's Room Happy Hour. So hopefully we'll see you coming up then. And today on The Question, what is your personal story involving a bug's life? We have quite a few. I'm not sure who Jamie Dornan is.
I had to look him up. And he is the guy. Now, I never saw the movie, but he was the male lead in the 50 Shades of Grey.
Oh, all right. So people do know who he is.
I know a lot of women certainly do.
I know a lot about him. Well, Jamie Dornan apparently thought he was having a heart attack and might die last year after he started experiencing telltale symptoms of what he thought was a heart attack. But he was just bugging out, so they say.
Oh.
Yeah. The actor's health scare was revealed through a friend of his, Scottish broadcaster Gordon Smart. He was on a BBC show, The Good, the Bad, and the Unexpected, where he told his wild story about him, Jamie, and some other pals. They were going to go down and hit Portugal last year. So after a night out, Smart says that some in their group started to feel really sick the next day. And Gordon actually was sent to the hospital as he felt tingling in his hand and arm. Smart thought he was having a heart attack, but was later told he'd been infected by a local caterpillar. Specifically, Smart says he was told he must have come in contact with a pine moth caterpillar.
Wait, that's not the full name.
A pine processionary moth caterpillar, which have poisonous hairs all over their bodies. If you don't know what it is, you never would have known that. They can infect humans. Typically, I'll skip over big words when I'm...
Now, I had to go over that word like seven times to put it in setup. Right. Like, no.
Big you words, say I read it. I'll skip them.
Processionary. And they are mostly native. I looked it up. So they're native mostly to, they say, like Southern Europe, the Mediterranean, Northern Africa.
Okay. Normally not deadly for people, but they can, in fact, kill animals. So anyway, he says he got back to the hotel room where Jamie was staying, and he saw Jamie, who was hooked up to medical equipment, and noted he had suffered from the same symptoms. Eventually, both of their symptoms cleared up, and in terms of how they might have come into contact with these things, Smart says they seemed to be all over golf courses there, which is where the boys were roaming just before coming down with their illness. He has not addressed the story himself, Jamie Dornan, but he said, it's a wild world out there. People take precautions, y'all. Caterpillar.
I mean, right. When that guy, you can't blame them. They're in their 40s.
And you don't know.
Right? Your left arm's tingling, goes numb. Another arm's going, like, you're like, yeah, I'm having a heart attack.
Yeah, you're at the age where every bad TV commercial applies to you.
That's right.
And if you're over 40, like, here we go.
Now we talk about one Sydney Sweeney. And as they say, she got a sneak preview of her upcoming role as Spider-Woman when a real spider bit her on the set of a different movie. And cameras captured her terrified reaction. It's an outtake from the set of her rom-com, Anyone But You. This was filmed in Australia. But it's hard to laugh when see the video and you hear her scream.
I'm just looking at her. I've heard her name. I decided
to. So she's in it. Wonder Woman.
Yeah. No, Spider-Woman.
Spider-Woman. Sid described it as a soul scream when she revealed the clip on Wednesday night on The Tonight Show. She said she was supposed to act as if the trained huntsman spider bit her.
So okay, just real
trained quick. Huntsman spider bit her.
Mike and I talked about this earlier. If someone says, I have trained my spider, and I don't mean trained it to find a piece of lettuce, I'm saying trained it like it can be on a movie set. Do you believe them?
Yes.
I would call out BS, but you did not train the spider. Spider's not trained.
So the trained huntsman spider actually bit her. She was supposed to act like that. But then it truly had a feisty nibble, they say, on her hand. Her eyes at the time are wide open in panic, and she shrieks at the top of her lungs while convincing others, including her co-star Glenn Powell. She is actually being bitten by this, and this is not fake. She's not acting.
Because the spider's not trained.
For the scene. they say huntsman spiders are widely lurking down under, and while their bites are painful, their venom does not harm humans. Docs are set immediately there to check her out, and she was fine. This all happened before she bagged her upcoming role in Marvel's Madame Web. So it's clearly a case of life imitating art, they say.
We still got that audio of her.
We do. Yes, we do.
What the f***? Oh, my God!
Got you?
It actually got you?
Cut.
Wow.
Yeah.
See, I hadn't heard that yet.
It's one of those trained spiders, Ted.
Yeah.
It bites for real,
I mean,
though.
Come on, man. A spider, and you're going to tell me it's trained. BS.
I mean, I know we're talking bugs, but I feel the same way about when they say that there's a trained bear on set. My ass. I'm not getting anywhere near it. Same reasoning right here.
I've always said that, right? Because especially when I was growing up, man, I feel like in the 70s, it was always man versus some type of animal kind of movies. And, you know, my parents explained, like, no, man, there's no CGI back then. They're like, no, these are real animals, and they're trained. I'm like, well, man, I hear what you're saying, but Ted is the bear trainer. Maybe the bear is cool with Ted, much like my dog is cool with me. Walk up to my front door, see how my dog responds, right? The other thing is, I know you're saying this bear's trained, but like when you say cut, does it understand what cut means? Because these movies we're filming, like, it's attacking me. And also, if I have to, like, charge this bear or charge a lion, like, does it know that I'm acting?
Right.
Does it know that I'm not actually trying to hurt it? Because any animal that believes it's being attacked is going to fight back.
Yeah.
There is no chance.
One of the most bizarre incidents I've seen lately involving bugs. I've had my run-ins with bugs before. I think we're pretty fortunate here in the Pacific Northwest as far as...
We don't have bad ones.
They're, right. The bugs are out there. We know what they are.
We just got giant-ass spiders from time to time.
We've got, you know, or we get some big-ass spiders.
Or if you're on a hike, you got those damn horse flies.
Horse flies?
They just
suck.
You
know what the crazy thing about them is? It seems like the higher you get in elevation, the more they show up. Like, you're almost going to get out of the forest canopy. Then when you get to the top where it opens up, those damn things are out there sunning, man. And
I hate them.
They are big. And
my hair is standing up just thinking about it.
They take a chunk of flesh with them when they leave you. You look down, you got a freaking hole in your shoulder or your arm.
Or if you're my father, on your forehead. And what made it better, we were kids, and we're in Rochester, New York. We're outside eating. And my dad's just holding conversation. We're eating, like, hot dogs. It's nothing, no big deal. And this big-ass horse flies, they are not tiny, man, lands directly on his bald spot. Picture like George Jefferson, right? Right on his bald spot, which somehow made it hilarious to me and my brother. Bit his head and took off.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Jumped up, screaming, knocked his plate over.
Well, speaking of just... There's a couple weird idiosyncrasies. I'll get to the story in a second. A couple of weird things I do. And, Ted, you know this. I always drink out of a glass. Whether there's a bottle, whether there's a can, if I can, I won't use a straw. I don't know what my weird deal is, but I definitely know for a fact.
Love a cup.
That when I started, when I gave up sodas in a can, it was a combined birthday party. My neighbors and a couple other people were having a birthday party. They had a cooler, and they just had cans of like whatever the big K cola, whatever the generic cola was at the time. I had my cola out. It was open. It was on the table. I was going to get my food, my hot dog, and everything else. I come back and take a drink. Next thing you know, I've got a bee in my mouth, and it stings the top of the roof of my mouth, which is impossible because that means the thing's like flying upside down in my mouth. Either way, it's the top. And it stung into my sinus cavities.
Right.
If that makes sense. Like it shot up in pain into my nose. And I'm like, ah! So that's why I never, I don't drink out of cans because I still have this weird thing where I just want to see what's in the can before I drink the can.
My father is exactly the same. If you ever see him drink anything outdoors and it's in a can, his hand, and it's automatic, as long as I've been alive, his hand just rests over the top. And when we finally asked him why, same story, but it didn't happen to him. It happened to either his cousin or his uncle, but he said same thing, they're drinking soda. His uncle kind of screams and throws the can, and as my father explains it, when everyone's like, what the hell is wrong with you, said he couldn't finish the sentence before his lip blew up. So it's like, I think it's... And everyone just fell out laughing, but my father said, look, based on the amount of pain that I saw this man in and what his face looked like after the bee stung his lip, it's like, nope. Just won't do it.
Okay, so I'm down in California. I'm playing golf. I know it's a shock to a lot of you. I'm down there by myself. I get paired up with three dudes. They're all locals from the area, real nice guys. And we get on hole number three, and one guy hits the ball kind of off the fairway a little bit in a sandy area. He goes over there. There must have been a beehive close, either in the ground or in the tree. I don't know where the bees were coming from. All of these guys had bananas in their cart, and I learned all this later. They had already eaten bananas, I guess, during the day. For whatever reason... And I just learned, it's like, bananas got some weird stuff. Like, don't take banana on a boat, blah, 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 blah.
Correct.
With bees.
And I love bananas.
Bees attack people with either the scent or the smell.
It's the pheromone in the banana.
Of bananas.
But it's, it was real specialized. Like, either it triggers their attack instinct, it says that they're in danger, but basically, if they smell this pheromone in a banana, they're coming after you.
Now, keep in mind, there are people behind us that are waiting for us to hit our shots to tee off. The bees start attacking these three guys. There's four of us. The bees are absolutely flying past me. It's a swarm of bees. They are leaving me the hell alone.
No, what's going when you if you don't know the banana thing at the time? No. Like, what are you thinking? Like, how am I not getting attacked? And why are these three guys? I mean, I know you're glad to be you
right.
in that moment, but like, do you think?
Well, I told them at the time. I was like, they're like, why? You know, like they weren't aware of what was going on either. And I joked today, it's because you're Hispanic, you know, because we were busting bees all day anyway. You know?
So, we were?
Yeah, we were. Actually, we were. These guys were killing each other.
I know people you golf with.
They were killing me, man.
All right.
They were killing everybody, but the bees were killing them. So they take off running in circles. And the people that are on the tee box behind us are thinking, what in the F is going on up there? And, I mean, this one guy just, he's running. And you see, like, the dust cloud of the bees behind it. And this is an older gentleman. He's, right. he's like in his late 50s. And he's just tearing as fast as he can. And he's going to the next hole. Well, his cart is still in the fairway, and his other buddy's taken off the other direction.
Right.
All right. And then the other buddy got in the cart, one of the carts, and is gone. Now, I have to go get their cart. Because both of the guys in the one cart, so I had to pull my cart out, then go back and run back. The cart's still in the middle of the fairway. I don't know where they are. The one guy is still running down the next hole fairway where there's other people down there, and he's still got a cloud of bees behind him. So this is the day that I learned that you do not eat bananas before you go out in areas where there are bees.
But no,
nests,
is
bees.
That the day you learned, or did you find out later?
That was the day that I learned.
That was the day. Okay.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, because we got back.
Can you have one in the morning? Just on,
no,
they have it in
no,
their cart.
No, you can't have one at all. Because I got in their cart, and their cart had bananas in it. And I drove that cart to the next hole, and the bees still did not attack me.
So you got to unpeel it. Basically, you got to let the stink out of the peel. I'm
assuming you have to ingest it. I don't know how this thing works out. I think your body lets off a pheromone or something.
And the bees, they just cannot help but want
to kill you.
Because
the bees are not on the banana. When I'm driving the cart, I can see there's bananas in the cart, and the bees are not, they don't care about the banana. So I don't know what in the hell the deal was, man, but it was just like, it was a circus. And there were tons of, I could not believe how many bees were around. And just like, seriously, what is this, man? Am I not tasty? Like, what
right.
is
it? You started to get upset.
Yeah, bees don't sting white people down here. Like, what the hell's going on? You know, it was just, it was bizarre as hell. And that was the day I learned. Oh, yeah.
Don't need a banana around bees.
Had no idea. What is your personal story involving a bug's life? 206-803-ROCK.
99.9 KISW. The shenanigans continue. This is the Men's Room with Miles and Thrill.
What is your personal story involving a bug's life? 206-803-ROCK.
Hello, Poggy. Welcome to the Men's Room.
What's up, fellas?
Hola.
So, this is about 30 years ago. I think I was 15 and I'm 45 now. I was hanging out with some of my cousins and aunt and uncles and some of their friends. And there was a beetle on the sidewalk. And my cousin's wife's like, I'll give you $5 if you eat that. And I was like, all right. I was supposed to be going to the Puyallup Fair the next day. So it was like sometime in September. And I was totally broke. I had a ticket to get in, but I was totally broke. I didn't have money for food or rides or anything. So my uncle went in the house and grabbed a handful of popcorn, and we put it in with a handful of popcorn, and I just ate it all, so it was just all crunchy.
Oh, that's not so bad with a handful of popcorn. That's a power move.
It wasn't too bad, but then the stakes got up later. I ended up eating a slug as well.
No.
I made like $50 altogether, I think, and had some food and a little bit of fun at the fair the next day.
Now, wait a minute. Was it $45 for the slug?
It was supposed to be, it was supposed to be $5 for the beetle, but she just gave me whatever she had in her purse. So it ended up being like $8.50. And then I got like $10 from four different people for the slug.
Okay.
All right. But at the fair, honest to God, that's about an hour's worth of entertainment.
That is.
I mean, I cannot believe how fast I spent money.
It was 30 years ago.
All right. Okay.
It was 30 years ago, so it lasted a little longer than it would now.
Yeah,
you're right.
When you got to the fair, knowing how you'd made your $48 and some change, did you think back like that totally worth it? Like I would do it again if I'm broke and going to the fair again?
Yeah, because it stayed down. I kept thinking all night at least the slug was going to come back up, and it never did.
What did you eat with the slug? I understand the popcorn with the beetle. That's smart thinking. Like, what did you mix with a slug?
An oyster.
They poured a little bit of Henry Weinhard's on it and a dash or two of salt.
Ah, so he shrunk up.
Like a beer or root beer?
Beer, even though I was 15, you know.
It's on a slug. I don't even think the cops would be in trouble for that.
If I'm making a teenager eat a bug, I don't think I'm against giving him a sip of beer.
That would be immoral.
I've already crossed the line.
Right.
The cops probably would have handed me a full one and said, here, wash it down with this.
All right, so since you've eaten both a beetle and a slug, have you ever had escargot?
I have not.
I think it's fantastic.
It's good. I mean, it tastes like whatever. Yeah. It tastes like garlic.
The times I've had it, garlic and butter.
How many times have you had it?
About three.
Really? I had it one time, and that was, and I wasn't going to try it, but you're like, dude, just try it. And it was surprisingly good. You just have mentally get out of your head what you're looking at, because they don't look any different.
I don't, there's no food in a shell that I don't enjoy. With the exception of maybe, I've never had conch.
Conch?
Never had conch.
It's okay. It's overrated.
I don't think I've ever had a gooey duck.
No.
They're not really in a shell, are they? Are they? Or are they just like
they kind of stick out of the shell. That's why they're
so odd.
So it's a razor clam that's the one that just kind
of
comes out like a giant penis.
No. That's the gooey duck.
That's the gooey duck, but he does have a bit of a shell on
him. He has a shell, but basically it's like you have an erection, your fly's open, okay. And you're going
commando.
The razor
clam is more like rectangle-shaped.
Oh, yeah. And it's got a big-ass shell on it, too.
Yeah.
Okay. It's just not a big ass.
I've just seen the innards of them, so I just kind of thought that was... Because basically, once you clean them up, that's what you get.
What's the other thing that's super fancy? You got to, dive in the water. Berdain would always go swimming for him. And it's like you crack it open, and there's, some little, stuff inside. It's sea urchin?
Sea urchin, yeah.
Ew, no. That's
terrible.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's...
That is the worst.
That's not good.
I mean, if you take someone to sushi for the first time ever and that's what you give them, they will never, ever trust you again in their life.
And they shouldn't. The only reason I tried it is because I was at a sushi place. I had established that I enjoyed all of the other sushis I tried, including eel. Because Miles, you convinced me. He said, dude, get the barbecue eel. I'm like, no. You're like, trust me. Delicious. So I'm like, sea urchin. I'll give it a try. Like, I will never do that again. Ever. Yep.
What is your personal story involving a bug's life? 206-803-ROCK.
Hello, Tom. Welcome to the men's room.
Hey, guys. How you doing?
Hola.
All right. So, yeah, I was riding my DRZ 400 SM dual sport bike down a Lake Lozenger Road, and I had a bee fly right into my helmet, right next to my temple. I don't know what kind of bee it was, but it was stinging me about 3 or 4 times before I could stop and get my helmet off.
What kind of damage did it do if you got stung that many times? Did your face blow up at all?
No, I'm not allergic to it or anything. It just kind of swelled up for like a day.
Oh, it still hurts.
Yeah, I mean, that's the thing. Allergic or not, it still sucks.
Kidding. It still hurts.
Yeah, like, I mean, I'm not allergic to a hammer, but if you hit me with one, it still sucks. I mean,
but the poison hits you immediately. Whatever that is.
Man. Yeah. Yeah.
Because, you think about it. You know, you go get a shot, whatever that shot is, a cold, flu shot or whatever the deal is, COVID shot. It might be a little, your area might be a little sore, but you don't have that stinging. And when a bee or anything else says, man, I mean, as soon as it hits, it's just like instant pain.
And I did not know this because I've been stung by yellow jackets a few times. I mean, yellow jacket, it's just like getting stabbed. And if they do have venom, it has no effect on me. Mm-hmm. Maybe they don't have venom. I don't know. So I just assumed that was the case with bees as well. And then the first time I got stung by a bee, man, yeah, seriously, the pain difference was significant. I'm like, okay. Yellow jackets don't bug me so much. It just hurts for a second. Bees, man, they suck.
People get stabbed and don't even know they got stabbed until they see the blood. A bee, man, it barely just... Ah! Oh, my God!
Yeah, last time I got stung by a bee, I saw it. It stung me on the hand, and I just had to sit there and pull his little stinger out real quick.
And it's
try
amazing.
To get the pain down.
When you look at the stinger, how much pain that itty-bitty, teeny-tiny thing can cause. It's almost annoying. That's all you put in my ass, and I am in pain. Thank you. Thank you, bee.
What is your personal story involving a bug's life? 206-803-ROCK.
Hello, Ron. Welcome to the men's room.
Hey, guys. Hola.
Hola.
Hey, yeah. So about 13 years ago, I'm working underneath my deck on my hot tub, and I felt a stinging on my lip, so I smashed it, and I didn't know what happened. But that afternoon, my lip swelled up to the size of a golf ball, my lower lip. And the next morning, I'm walking up my stairs, and I felt some pain in my left cheek of my ass. And, well, what in the hell? I mean, it hurts. And then the pain kept on getting worse. And later that evening, my wife, she told my mom, she had to work. She said, you need to get out here. Ron's in bad shape. And so I remember my mom coming out, and I blacked out from the pain.
Damn.
Now, when you say the pain got worse, did it also spread?
Absolutely. So, and I've got more broken bones and dislocations and surgeries than 10 men. I had that adrenaline junkie stuff going on earlier in my life. But anyway, so... I'm in the hospital. My mom calls the aid wagon. I'm in the hospital. And here's what they told me after I came to. They said, call the family in. He's got a 25% chance. And they found out it ended up being a spider. And so the venom went right to my pelvic bone, my left cheek of my butt. And it was eating a hole in my bone.
Jesus.
And it was the most, childbirth got nothing on this, dude. And so, I'm telling you what. And so I was in there. I wanted to go home so bad. I was in there. The morphine, they give you every 30 minutes. And I couldn't hit that SOB fast enough. And I was on so many, on the antibiotics, after 2 weeks. I hadn't gone to the bathroom, you know what I mean?
Sure.
In 2 weeks. And the poor nurse, it was the size of a frickin' football. I mean, it was that poor thing. It was just,
ah! Did you, well, you obviously gave birth too. Do you know what kind of spider it was?
No, they're thinking it was a brown recluse.
Okay.
But, you know, I smashed it. So, anyway.
But you have no recollection of this thing biting you or being on you or anything.
No, well, I felt the stinging in my lip.
Right.
So, and that was, okay, so
I,
okay.
I hit my face. I knew it was some kind of a bug or something. I didn't know because it was, I didn't have my light underneath there. Anyway.
And you're in the hospital for 2 weeks, you said.
So 2 weeks go by, and the doctor says it because I wanted to go home so bad. They go, well, you got to walk up the stairs, go down the hallway. And I did. It was the most excruciating every step. So I went to a wheelchair, got home, went to a wheelchair, a walker, crutches, and a cane. And it took about 4 months for me to get, you know.
From
one spider bite to the lip.
Yep.
Good God, man. And are there any lasting effects from this?
Nope. I'm all... Like I said, 13. I'm in construction. I don't feel a thing now.
I wonder if you were to bite. I wonder if a spider, same type, were to bite you again. If your body would have some resistance to just how bad that attacked you,
or if your body says, "Not this ass again. I'm killing."
Right, dying.
Yeah.
Where were you at?
Yeah. I was at home in Lake Stevens.
All right, that makes you feel awful.
It could happen to you.
Yeah.
So you said though that this venom, it gets to the point where it starts eating a hole in your bone. Does it self-heal after they give you all the antibiotics and all that?
What's that?
Does it self-heal after they give you all the antibiotics, or is there just a tiny hole in your bone?
I had to have the tube put in my arm, and the nurse had to give myself self-injections every single day, and it was a close one, man.
So what happens if you see a spider now? Because I would think after that experience, you're breaking out a blowtorch.
I don't worry about stuff like that. No.
All right. Well, good for you, man.
Yeah.
Good for you.
God, that's crazy.
I already don't like spiders. That certainly does not help the case.
And again, it doesn't sound cool. Like, you get, like I say this all the time, but like, Ted got mauled by a bear. Sucks, but like, damn, he went out.
But what's a person?
But
right.
A spider bites, like, that's
on my
it?
Lip, and then ate a bone, or ate a hole in my pelvic region.
It's like fish in the ocean. What's the percent that could really harm you? So, you know a shark can, but with spiders, is it 85% of the population could really mess you up or
I'm
going to
say it's on the low end, right? Because we know black widows, we've heard about the brown recluse, but even like Sydney Sweeney getting bitten by that huntsman, it hurts.
He can't kill her.
But it's not going to kill you.
Yeah.
Right? So, man, I don't know, but I imagine it's on the low end.
Yeah, for the most part.
But it seems like these things that kill you with venom is always the worst way to go, right? So they say, hey, how do you want to die? Do you want to die where you're attacked by a great white shark? Do you want to go Ted's route and you're mauled by a bear, or do you want to be bitten by a venomous spider? I think you might just take the shark.
Well, because the spider's going to happen from the inside out.
That's what I'm saying. Like, I think I would rather just be bitten in half, bleed out, and let it be done.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but you also are probably going to drown. That's why I'm having the bear maul me.
You're going for the bear?
Oh, every day of the week.
Yeah, but they stink.
And it's going to be violent and awful death.
It's going to be
but I don't want to
drown. It's
going
to be really smelly.
And I don't want my legacy to be, hey, I got bit by a spider.
Yeah, right. There's just something that's not as cool.
Right.
I'm taking a shark.
But again, it would suck. But at least with the bear, it's like, did you hear how Ted went out?
Okay, how about this? How about this? So we sold the venomous spider, and we take the bears out.
All right.
We take sharks out. But the ultimate nightmare to me, the chimpanzee.
Well, yes, of course.
You're taking the chimpanzee over the spider?
No, I'm just saying that would be the one I would pick least.
Yeah, I'm taking the spider.
No, I'm not, because I don't want my junk ripped off.
That's the issue.
That's their first move. Keep in mind.
And your face destroyed.
But think about how stupid this is. Our scenario is you're going to die, but we still agree I don't want my junk ripped off before it's going to kill me.
The chimpanzee more than likely is not going to kill you. That's the problem. You're going to survive the rest of your life with no face and no junk.
And that lady in Connecticut.
Yep.
Still doesn't have a face.
What is your personal story involving a bug's life? 206-803-ROCK.
By the way, one of the texts here, it just came out of nowhere. It says, ate at Taco Bell. Biggest mudslide ever. Not piecing it together. Well, they send in another text. Bug's life? My bad. Thought you sent mudslide.
Jeez, so mudslide.
Now we know you don't do well. I could not figure out what they were talking about. Then they texted a couple minutes later, like, my bad. Misunderstood. Hello, Tom. Welcome to the men's room.
Hola.
Hola.
Okay, about 7 or 8 years ago, my company sent me to Beaumont, Texas to work after the hurricanes. And I was inspecting homes for damage. A lot of them were vacant. Did a lot, you know, so I was working by myself. I'm at this one house. I walk into the backyard. All of a sudden, I get hit in the cheek with a rock. But then I figured out it's not a rock. It's some big insect. Right about then, I get stung right between the shoulders. And these things started swarming around. They were Asian murder hornets.
Oh, God, I'd forgotten about them. Yeah.
Uh-huh. And this sting hurt worse than any, it's like getting stung by 50 bees at once. And so I was wondering if I should go to urgent care, but you know, I was kind of embarrassed. So I looked the next day, I had a welt between my shoulders about the size of the palm of my hand.
Damn.
It ended up getting infected because the stinger was in there. I get home 2 weeks later, I'm getting my son, who is very, very detail-oriented and very organized, to remove it. And he's being very methodical, but he's a nice kid, and his hands were shaking. My wife comes up, says, give me the tweezers. Just jabs them in my back and gets that thing out. And that was almost as bad as the sting.
Yeah, dude, if you give your wife the opportunity to dig something out of your body when it's on your back, they are merciless.
Did that make the swelling go down and the infection go away?
Yeah, it did. And then we, you know, washed it out and stuff. But yeah, no, I wanted my son to do it because I knew he'd be methodical and delicate about it. The old mom just says, hey, come on.
Yeah, wives do not care. They'll jab anything in you to, quote unquote, help you out. So at the time that things attacked you, were you aware that they were murder hornets or were they just some giant ass stinging bug as far as you knew?
No, I just thought they were just some giant stinging bug. And I later found out they were the murder hornets. But each one of these, if you look at your pinky finger, and they are about as big as the last two knuckles.
Yeah, I've heard they're big. I haven't had any interaction. Now, was this before Washington State started getting a few murder hornets?
Yes. Yeah, they've been down in the southern states for a long time.
So what is your reaction? Because everyone else, you know, you watch the news and they say, hey, man, there's these Asian murder hornets, blah, blah, blah. And we say, okay, sounds like bad news. Try to steer clear. But none of us have any real idea of how bad it was. I mean, did you kind of go into a cold sweat like, oh, tell me these bitches are not here now?
No, but where I really got concerned was that there was a swarm of them around. And, you know, I have heard that if like between 20 or 50 of them sting you, that they can kill you.
Jesus.
So you said you thought you got hit by a rock in the cheek. Are they that big?
Yeah. And it was one of them going in to sting me on the cheek.
And was there any provocation? Like, did you disturb their nest or you were just physically present?
No, I was walking by a bush where they were nested. Now, I was wearing a black golf shirt and a black golf cap, so that might have had something to do with it.
Really?
They hate golfers?
Are you just speculating there, or have you heard that?
No, I'm just speculating because I heard that black irritates bees.
Oh, trust me, I've heard many things.
All right. Bees, too.
Huh? Oh, yeah, bees, too. Oh, okay.
One more to the list.
Wow.
What is your personal story involving a bug's life? 206-803-RUN.
My hair is just standing up, period, now.
Well, from the stories?
Yeah, this question just give me the... Yeah.
Well, see, like, the murder hornets I find fascinating because, one, I've never had any interaction. I never physically saw one other than what they showed on the news. it's when they talk about like the brown recluse spider biting you. Like, that's a very reasonable thing that can happen, you know, in my home. Those are the ones that bug me.
I had a pretty good size wolf spider that was out on my deck where I smoke, right by my grill. And I could see him out there.
How can you tell it? Like, I can't. Other than like a black widow.
He was just big and hairy. That's about the size of your palm, and he was hairy as hell. So I just assumed he's a big old wolf spider. But either way, he would he'd make his nest in between the railings on my porch. So every time I got high and he was out there, I'd go and I'd blow smoke all over him. I mean, at least two or three just.
Did he start making crazy webs?
It was really entertaining to watch him go to work.
Oh yeah. Have you seen the videos of, like, spiders? They dosed them with...
You can get them stoned.
You can. They did an experiment where they dosed a couple of spiders with a very small dose of acid. And then these spiders went and made webs. And honest to God, it looks like a spider on acid made the web. Like, normally they are precision when they do it. But you get them high on whatever, man.
It's just this random abstract thing. Like, there's no way it's catching a fly. It's just not... The web's not tight.
Even a fly is like, dude, you're high.
The web is a double helix.
It's basically fly right through it. The holes are so big you can drive a truck through it. What is your personal story involving a bug's life? 206-803-ROCK.
At Metro by T-Mobile, there's not a yada yada. That means no contracts, no price hikes, and no surprises. We don't even hide what the lawyers make us say. We put it first. When we say no price hikes, we mean when you join Metro, your price will never increase for talk, text, and smartphone data. Our only exclusions are for limited time promos, free charges, and third-party services. Nada yada, nada yada yada, nada yada, nada yada yada. Nada yada yada means wireless without the gotcha. Only at Metro.
McDonald's presents Burger Reviews by Hamburglar, the classic cheeseburger. Hamburglar?
Rubble, rubble.
He said, the patties are juicier than ever before.
Ba-da-ba-ba-ba.
Rubble. Available at most restaurants in this area.
What's up? It's your boy, The Ted Smith from The Men's Room. And did you know I have a podcast? Well, I do. The Podcast. New episodes uploaded every Wednesday on the Odyssey app.
9.9 KISW. We return to the men's room with Miles and Thrill.
For the first time in 221 years, two cicada broods will emerge together. This coming April, a swath of the country will soon be buzzing loudly with up to a trillion cicadas.
Yeah.
This April will mark the first time since 1803 with a dual emergence of two periodical cicada groups. We have the Great Southern Brood. They come out every 13 years. Then you've got the Northern Illinois Brood, and they emerge every 17 years. This spring, it'll be another 221 years before the broods, which are geographically adjacent, appear together again. Now,
and here's the thing. We do not get cicadas out here, at least not those types of broods. Went through it twice when I lived in Maryland, because it is once every 17 years. I cannot explain... They are harmless. They do not sting. They do not bite. But they're super loud, and they cover every available surface because they're... I mean, the outside of your building will be black with red eyes. Every tree is covered top to bottom. Your lawn is covered. It's unbelievable.
So what they're saying is that the combination of these two broods will more than likely lead to crossbreeding between the two species, which will create a new brood set to a new cycle, an extremely rare event, according to an entomologist at the Smithsonian National Museum of Natural History. Here's where it hits hard. Georgia, Alabama, Mississippi, Louisiana, Arkansas, Oklahoma, Missouri, Kentucky, Tennessee, North Carolina, Virginia, Indiana, Illinois, Iowa, and Wisconsin, all the primary states that'll get it. Everything on the peripheral,
you still
get that. You're still going to get some of those cicadas. So
Maryland to New Jersey to New York. It's not, again, it is hard to explain how thick... How thick life becomes with cicadas when these things come out. They are everywhere.
And they're so loud, and they're big for a bug. So, like, I was back east the last time they were out, and I was in Maryland, like, D.C. area for a couple days. And, like, even when you're sitting out in the yard, like, you know they're around, but when one lands on your neck or something, you're like, tch!
And I said, they might freak you out because they look menacing, right? Jet black body, these bright red eyes. But again, they don't do anything. Turns out they're actually very stupid, even for an insect. They can't fly well. They got little hooks for feet. But the big problems you have, other than people just freaking out about them, is that it's like 8 billion chicken nuggets have been put on the ground for your dog to
eat. They're noisy.
And the problem is, when your dog eats them, then your dog gets sick. But dogs cannot resist eating this plentiful source of bugs. So that's one thing. I'm like, don't let your pets eat it. Well, no one's letting their pet doing it. But again, they're walking on top of them. they start eating these damn things. The birds have a field day, and again, we cannot explain how loud they are. I think they said their mating call, and it's constant. They don't do it every once in a while. It is just one weird scream.
Yeah.
24 hours a day. It's 100 decibels. They said it's like listening to a jackhammer.
And to give you an idea,
24 hours a day for 2 weeks.
These guys have some very reflective red eyes.
Mm-hmm.
So Chewy used to eat them like crazy. The other dog did not. But when I would walk them at night even, you know, you're on a sidewalk, you're underneath a streetlight, your dog drops a deuce. You go to pick it up, and the reflection off the streetlight is aimed at two red eyeballs that are lodged in a turd.
Yeah, looking at you from a piece of poop.
You are, it's full, the whole thing is full of wings and pieces of bugs. And
it's a really crappy 2 weeks in your spring. Like, nobody gets
I think
hurt.
It's longer than that. It's like two or three or four, maybe. It seems like it's forever. It seems like a whole month goes by.
So it's a weird thing.
Because some start coming out earlier than others, and then you have some that, yes, it is 17 years, but they all don't come out on the same day.
Right, it's not the same day.
You know, like there's a 2 or 3 week time period where they're all popping out of the ground. So as long as they live, they live.
Have you ever seen them before they pop out of the ground?
I have never dug it into the ground and found some that were in
it. I did not. It was cicada season, same thing. Just everything we described. They're everywhere. They're screaming. They're doing all this kind of thing. But my mother had some kind of big paving stone in the backyard. She wanted my father and I to move it. So we did. And we did not realize that as they're coming out of the ground, these were not going to get out because they were under the stone. But we picked up the stone and it was still, keep in mind, the stone's maybe 3 foot by 3 foot. But we lift this thing up. There had to be 100 more, but they're like albino white.
Okay.
It is the right. Weird. Yeah. When they're underground, man, they're pure white. And somehow it looked even creepier.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's, man, I don't like those.
Nothing things. Should be that white.
No, but, no.
What is your personal story involving a bug's life? 206-803.
They were Utah white.
I'm just saying, like.
Hello, Ron. Welcome to the men's room. Hello, Ron.
Ron.
Hola.
We'll get back to Ron. Hello.
The outside of like a, what? What's the tiger that's white?
Siberian?
Yeah. But other than that, most animals or anything that's albino, you're like, eh.
It does look weird. Even a polar bear, when you really look at it, is more tan than bright white.
Beluga whale looks friendly.
Beluga whale's white.
Well, they have some albino ones. They have a white species.
Really?
Because
Really?
That comes up and visits people on the boat in England or whatever, and people are freaking out because they want to protect him. Maybe it's Spain or whatever the deal is, but he keeps coming up and talking to people and doing his thing.
I feel like they're white for the most part. Like, yeah. I don't think they're even albino. I think they're just white whales.
Yeah, I think they are white.
Yeah, come on, Miles. I'm not albino. There's nothing wrong with me, man.
I know the whiteies.
I'm just white. Damn.
What is your personal story involving a bug's life? 206-803-ROCK.
Hello, Eli. Welcome to the men's room.
Hola.
Hola. Hola.
Okay, so check this out. I'm 60 years old now. It happened about 10 years ago. So I'm moving out of the house, you know, and I got my have a trailer. It's parked in my driveway, and on my driveway along the sides, I have these old railroad ties, right? And I had noticed, you know, that there was some bee activity within the holes, right?
All right.
I paid no mind to it, right? So I'm moving out, and I'm moving furniture. I have my trailer there, and actually, I had called my friend of mine just down the street. I said, "Hey, bro, I need some help, man. I need some help moving my furniture," right? So he's like, "All right, dude, I'll be there by 9, right? I'm like, okay, cool. So I start working, and then, you know, these bees, they turn out to be wasps, right? So I'm loading something into the trailer, and this one wasp just comes up, and boom, man, it hits me. It hits you right on the top of the head, right? And I'm like, oh, shoot. I put my hand to it, you know, and I could feel the wasp. And I'm like, oh, duh, got it, you know. And as I did that, I turn and I see my friend coming up the street. And I'm like, dude, I gotta go inside. I'm gonna take some, I'm gonna take some Motrin, right?
No.
So I go in there, and he follows me into the house. And I go in there and I grab my Motrin. I've got some water, and I just shove it down my throat, and then. When he comes in, you know, I'm like, all right, bro, let's go. And he goes, dude, did you look at your face? I'm like, what? And I'm like, no. So I went back into the bathroom, and my face is just like, boom. I'm just like, holy potatoes. I'm like, oh, my God.
It swelled up that fast?
Huh?
Your face swelled up that fast. That's amazing.
That bad? I mean, from walking from my driveway into my house. I mean, it was like 15, 20 seconds at the most.
But did they form your face? I mean, did you look like what? Eric
Were
Stoltz?
You puffy? Were you red?
Elephant Man or what?
Puffy. It was just like you know those comic, those like on TV when they show a character gets bit by a bee and blows up like that. And I'm like, whoa. And then I start getting this pain in my chest, and I'm like, oh, and I'm like, okay, I know I'm in trouble, right? So my buddy says, I said, you know what? Take me to the hospital. Here's my truck. I got my keys. I said, you know, I said, go with me. And then, so I'm VA, right? I'm a veteran, and about a mile, maybe a mile is the VA hospital. So then I'm like, just take me to the VA hospital. And I said, you know, just, I'm about to get into the truck, and then I'm like, oh, I get these crushing pain in my chest. It's just like, oh, my God. I'm like, oh, and I can't breathe, and I'm like, and I give him the keys. I'm like, never mind, because it was like, I said, instead of going to the VA, I said, no VA. You know,
why didn't you want to go to the VA if you feel like you're having, quote, a crushing pain in your chest?
Yes, but you see, the VA was about a mile away. There was the Boys Town. This was in Omaha, right? The Boys Town Hospital, it's just like past that distance. So I'm like,
okay.
Take me there. Oh, dude, I'm just like, I get the worst crushing pain. I think I'm going to die. I mean, I ended up in the emergency room. I had these chest pains. I ended up in the hospital, and they did all kinds of stuff. And I'm like, no, you know. They said, no, it was just an allergic reaction. I've never, ever been, you know, stung by anything. So, okay, you know, I mean, the whole thing, I mean, I thought I was going to die, right? You fast forward about a year, right? And I'm at an office picnic, and my director, you know, we're at a park, and there's, you know, there's bees and stuff like that. And then he says, hey, so I heard you had an allergic reaction to bees. And I'm like, yeah. And as I'm telling him, I said, yeah, so I'm explaining, you know, I'm at the house, I'm loading car, I see my friend, and then as I look to my friend, something hit me in the head, and I put my hand on my head, and there was another bee there, and it stung me again, and I'm like, oh, crap.
Did you go through the same, the whole thing happen again?
Yeah, to the same thing, so.
Do you smell like a banana?
Are you eating a ton of bananas, man?
No. See, what happened was we had this contest at work, and it's like it's a fundraiser. So they, you know, they put votes against you for $1, and you know whoever gets the most votes gets a pie in the face, right? It's just a whipped cream and stuff like
sure.
that. My the guy that I work with, he was feeling generous. He put in like $150 on me. So you know, I ended up having the pie in my face. I had an option to, you know, I think I had like $170 on my name. So I said, okay, you know, I can pay $170 and then the number two gets it. But that's why I ended up with all this whipped cream in my face. And that's basically what happened was the beating that I had been. And my first exposure, I never, you know, been, you know, stung. So they gave me those things that you stick in your butt, you know, the quick anaphylactic stuff.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So, I had them, and then the second time that I got it stung, we were at this like a picnic way over there, and I'm like, oh, I told my wife, you're gonna drive me home. She's like, okay. So we get to my house, about 15 minutes later, and I'm all swollen up, and those injection things, they're expired, and she won't give them to me. And I'm like, no, it's expired. You might die. And I'm like, oh, my God.
Yeah, you don't need to be stung by a bee. That's fact. That sounds like a horrible time.
Good Lord, man. People well, enjoy the sound.
Typically, if you do have that stuff on hand, most of the time it is expired if you need it.
Yeah,
I know for a fact.
Hopefully
like,
it's not
like
something
like
you
inhalers
need.
For people who have asthma attacks, herpes medication, you name it. It's got a shelf life of like 3 months. It's just like you go to get it, and you're like, oh no, 2012.
Bad news. That's not going to work.
Exactly.
We were talking about cicadas earlier. And somebody, listen, look, the one thing about cicadas, they don't sting, so this guy would have no problem. They don't bite. They're just stupid. So nobody gets hurt. Somebody said, well, people do get hurt from the car accidents from it being slippery. And that's actually, we actually do have a story about a woman. She, and it's not, the cicada did anything. It was her reaction to a cicada showing up in her car.
You got to use your wipers because the cicadas will just run into your windshield.
We go to Cincinnati, Ohio. What ABC News calls an amorous cicada flew into a vehicle's window, causing the car to crash. The accident happened at about 6:30 in the evening when the insect flew into the car as it was making its way along a road there, hit the driver in the face. This startled the driver. They ended up veering off the road and then smashing into a utility pole. The driver was not badly hurt, though the car was badly damaged, and the cicada was declared dead at the scene, according to the Cincinnati Police Department.
Oh, cool. That's what we wanted to know, yeah.
Yes. Our question, what is your personal story involving a bug's life? 206-803-ROCK.
Hello, Dave. Welcome to the men's room.
Hola, fellas.
Hola.
Okay, so this happened when I was living in Florida right before I moved up to the PNW. Came home from, I built cell towers, so I came home from work one day, was going to the bathroom, you know, do my bathroom thing or whatever. And as I flip on the light, I see this bug on the mirror. Well, it instantly flies off the mirror. It does a circle around the room and then right into my right eyeball.
Oh.
Said bug was a flying ant. Well, it gripped on to the white part of my eyeball, my pupil.
Okay.
when I say gripped on, now I started screaming. It hurt. Right. Well, my wife comes in. Well, she has to get tweezers, and she's pulling it off, and it's pulling part of my eyeball with it. Like, it will not let go. She finally gets it to let go. And, you know, disposed of it or whatever. But for like 3 weeks, there was a zit on my eyeball.
Oh, man.
I mean, it's awful.
Did it just itch and sting all the time?
Oh, yeah. Oh, constantly. My whole eye swelled up. But like I said, there was a zit in the middle of my eyeball.
Do you miss Florida?
That was in Florida.
Do you miss living there?
The cold and wet up here sucks, man.
Well, that does affect. You're not going to get bit by a flying ant.
You will appreciate it in the summer. Exactly. Like, our bugs are like bees and houseflies. Mm-hmm. You don't get these big, giant-ass, weird, crazy things.
It's not warm enough for the bugs to actually thrive.
You literally have to be in the woods.
In Florida, the bugs get big, so mosquitoes fly in like Hueys, and, you know, just accept it, Florida.
I will say the biggest bugs I've seen in my life personally were all in Florida. Florida and Texas. Mm-hmm. If it is hot and humid, man, they become freaking monsters, man.
Yeah, there's
some. And then you guys say things like,
there's a lot of things in Florida that'll kill you.
Yeah. But you guys say things like, oh, dude, don't worry about it, man. It's just a cockroach. I'm like, okay, well, where I'm from, a cockroach is not this size.
Right.
You understand what I'm saying?
A cockroach is like 3.5 inches, bro.
There was my stepfather and his wife. They go to they go to Virginia Beach every year. They have a timeshare condo. So I think they get a couple weeks a year.
All right.
But they go typically for Thanksgiving or whatever. So I called my stepfather to wish him a happy Thanksgiving. He is driving to their destination for a couple weeks. And he said, yeah, man, I'm in the car. We're going down. And I said, well, so Virginia Beach? He said, no. We're going to Nag's Head. And I said, oh, you want a Nag's Head? That's a little bit longer of a drive. You know what? I thought you had that timeshare. Don't you guys have that anymore? And he said, I'll tell you about that later. Yeah. So, because his wife was in the car. So eventually, like, I talked to him a week later. And I was like, why did you end up going down to Outer Banks? And he's like, well, to be honest with you, he's like, the last time we were in Virginia Beach condo, Elisa saw a cockroach, and now she won't walk in anymore.
Oh, really?
I was like, just one cockroach? He's like, one cockroach. And now I have to drive 3.5 more hours.
You've got to be kidding.
One cockroach.
That's wild.
And I was like, it's that bad? He's like, she won't even walk in the building anymore. So I don't know. I think it was one of those timeshares where you have the option to either trade or stay in other places.
That's usually how timeshares work. Yeah, you could stay somewhere else.
They didn't lose their time, but they lost their location. It was like their permanent kind of location, I guess. They're like, they were booked for it every year or whatever.
Yeah.
So either way.
One cockroach.
One cockroach.
Damn, man.
That's all it took. One cockroach.
3.5 hours longer. That's commitment.
No, baby, figure it out. We're going to Virginia.
Exactly. It's like, how do you talk your significant other into, like, you know, not having this fear or this phobia? But a cockroach isn't going to hurt you. It's not that big of a deal.
Don't look for it.
Exactly.
That's all.
They're hiding from you. What is your personal story involving a bug's life? 206-803-ROCK.
Maximize the compensation for your injury claim with Phillips Law Firm. With over 80 years of combined legal experience, they won't allow the insurance companies to dictate what's good enough for you. Whether it's an auto accident or workplace injury, contact Phillips Law Firm today. If they don't win, you don't pay.
Do relationships have to be easy to be right? Of course not. The best relationships with friends, family, or partners happen when both people put in the time and commitment to make them great. Therapy can help. BetterHelp offers convenient, affordable online therapy. Start the process in minutes and switch therapists anytime. Give your relationship some love with BetterHelp. Visit BetterHelp.com/positive today to get 10% off your first month. That's BetterHelp, HELP.com/positive.
Shall I take your order, or do you need a minute?
Yes, I'll be ready. Just buying a car on Carvana.
What?
It's super convenient. I already got pre-qualified in 2 minutes. All I had to do was answer a few questions.
What? That's handy.
Yeah, now I'm customizing my down and monthly payments.
What? That's an exquisite deal.
And just like that, Carvana's delivering my car in a couple days.
What?
Oh, yeah. Sorry, I'll have the burrito.
Visit Carvana.com to finance your next car.
Financing subject to credit approval. Delivery fees may apply.
Searching for a beach getaway the whole family will love? Newport, Oregon is your front door to outdoor adventure and exploration. Featuring miles of sandy beaches and ocean. Perfect for beachcombing, fat tire bicycling, kayaking, kite flying, and hiking. And explore Newport's historic bayfront with canneries, fish markets, art galleries, gift shops, and eateries. You might even spot a sea lion. Your adventure starts at discovernewport.com. That's discovernewport.com.
99.9 KISW. The Men's Room returns with Miles and Thrill.
There's now Daily and Steve Mix coming up from the Daily Mix Morning Show. We're going to send spin. We've got 10 songs about sobriety.
Yay.
As we celebrate Dry January coming up right after emails on our question. What is your personal story that involves a bug's life? 206-803-ROCK.
Hello, Joshua. Welcome to the Men's Room.
What's up, gentlemen?
Hola.
So, probably about 25 years ago, I was really big into soccer. I was, this happened in Illinois. I'm currently in Washington now, but we had just finished soccer practice and just kind of playing around a little bit as everybody's leaving. All of a sudden, I heard a loud clank. In the forest, right next to our area where we practiced, and within seconds, I think I looked over and saw something falling out of the tree, and instantly started feeling some stings under my shirt. So I was like, "What the heck is that?" And I start feeling more and more. And coach comes running over to me, seeing what's going on, while everybody's cleaning up, and it looks like. The they're called the bald face hornets, the black and white ones that make those giant paper mache type.
Ah, okay, yeah.
Yeah, apparently some kids, the area we practice has this dirt ramp jump area called the Jefferson Jumps, and a lot of young high schoolers go over there, so I guess somebody decided to throw a rock over at the nest, and I just happened to be the closest one moving around next to it. And my coach and my mom had to rush me into a van and kind of pat me down, take off my shirt. But it was about 20 of those little suckers all over me. Tons of welts everywhere. I remember I had to go home, take an ice bath just to help get that swelling down. It was rough.
Did you have to go to the hospital at all?
No. Shockingly, I guess the ice bath helped. It was, you know, kind of close to home. We had just finished, so there was no, even at that age, I guess there was no super bad results. I've got a pretty high tolerance for pain. I don't know if it's because of that, but yeah, quite an experience. Would not want to relive that again.
That's what I learned today, man. Bugs suck.
Yeah, yeah.
Seriously. These stories are just horrible.
Yeah.
I don't. One sting is bad enough for me.
Right, one sting sucks.
I mean, like, look, I could get stung by a bee on a Saturday, come in here on Monday, and I'd still be bitching about it.
Dude, it still hurts.
Yeah. I swear to God, I come in here, like, you're not going to believe what happened to me. Frickie got stung by a bee, man.
The two times I got stung by yellow jackets, on both occasions, it was essentially the hive. And I know not all of them in the hive got me, but you're talking 30, 40 stings. But again, there's no venom, so it just kind of hurt. Mm-hmm. You know, someone poking you 40 times with the needle. Been stung by a bee now twice in my life, and both I would rather be stung by the hive of yellow jackets than a single bee. Because the last time I got stung by a bee, playing basketball with my kid out front, I think I did not realize that they'd made their nest inside of the tube holding the thing up. We hit the backboard, rattled that thing. They came out, they stung him, they stung me. And I always remember, he was real young, so he looks at me with his eyes all bugged up. He goes, what do we do? I'm like, run!
Right?
Run! Yeah. Do exactly what you think you should do.
My buddy Pat, the worst, I don't know if it matters if they're in the ground or in the, you know, in an ass.
I don't know.
But my buddy Pat, he had a brand new Lawn Boy lawnmower.
All right,
and
big rider.
It was a push mower, but it had like a bag on the back.
Yeah, mm-hmm.
So it was not a side chute, but it like shot out the back. But anyway, so he ran over one of these holes, and the bees just started coming out. He freaked the hell out. So he takes off running inside the house. A couple got him, whatever. Closes the door. You know, he's out there. The lawnmower is continuing to run.
I've had that experience myself.
So he calls his dad at work, and his dad says, "Look, just don't go back out there. Just let the lawnmower run, and you know I'll come home." And so when his dad gets home, lawnmower's still running. It's been like 2 hours. The thing is still going. It's still going strong. His dad goes out there. There's no real bees in sight, so he shuts the lawnmower off, and then he hears this humming. You know, just this huge swarm sounds. He's like, "Look," his idea was, "I'm going to grab this thing by the handle. I'm going to take off running. I'm going to put it in the garage. And I'm going to close the garage door because they're back in the nest.
Right.
I just want to get this thing out of the yard." He tears off running down, pulling this freaking lawnmower, goes into the garage, shuts the garage door, realizes when he's in there that all the bees are in that back catcher bag, or at least half of them.
Right.
They got sucked up through the lawnmower as it was running, and they were trying to come out the hole. They were all kind of trapped in that bag. So basically what he did was he took the nest from outside and brought it in his garage and shut the door.
Yeah, right.
And so then when he opened the door back again, when he figured out what was going on, he's like, there's 20 bees that have worked their way out. Now he's got to push that lawnmower back outside,
shut
the garage door again, close the door to the house, because now he's got like 20 bees in his garage. Lawnmower's still full of bees outside. And the thing was it was a brand new lawnmower.
Right.
This is a brand new lawnmower. So he didn't want to leave it out. You know, it was like his pride and joy. You know, it was like a $500 lawnmower back then. What is your personal story involving a bug's life? 206-803-ROCK.
Hello, Jeff. Welcome to the men's room.
Hola.
Hola.
So 11 years ago, I was traveling in South America in Bucaramanga, Colombia. Where I eventually lost my life. And I was staying at a friend's house, and I woke up one morning with a little blood on my cheek, and I didn't think anything of it. The house didn't have air conditioning, no screens on the windows or anything. It's like 90 degrees all the time down there.
Hello?
And was a bot fly at the eggs in my face.
So a bot fly. So basically, if a bot fly is an adult, it doesn't really do anything to you. But what they do is they lay their eggs under your skin, and then the babies, essentially, right? They break through your skin and go on to live their nice, happy life.
Yeah, it started to itch day later. Then I had like a little hole that I could look in the mirror and kind of open up and pick at. Started to get infected, but luckily down there, you don't have to go to the hospital or anything. There's like a pharmacy on every corner in every neighborhood. So I went to the local pharmacy, and the guy there said, "Oh, yep, bot fly laid eggs in your face."
Which I guess,
wait till it gets ripe to press the eggs out.
You press the eggs out, like popping a zit.
Yeah.
Interesting. Did any of them, here's a picture, Miles. I can't move my computer around because, of course, it'll just gonna.
Oh, no.
So that's what it looks like, the fly.
Oh,
and then that's the thing climbing out of your skin.
No.
It was my face. It looked like I got punched in the face. It was so embarrassing. Almost a week.
Man, I would be less about the embarrassment and more about how skeeved out I am.
Yes.
There's just something about the idea of something living in you. Like when I was a real little kid, my brother brought up tapeworms. I was completely unfamiliar. And of course, there's no internet. So he goes to like the encyclopedia and shows me a picture of this thing. And I mean, like, it crippled me mentally. I'm like, wait, what? And he explained what they are, how they get there, where it's living, how they get them out. And I was just like, dude, I probably sweated tapeworms for like 2 years after that. You know, everything I ate, like, oh my God, please don't get a tapeworm. Mm-hmm. And I would say to this day, they're pretty skeevy as far as things go.
Any idea of you being used as a host will just freak you the F out.
When you call someone a host, it makes you feel bad.
I kind of like my salmon raw on the inside a little bit, just as far as the taste goes and the texture of it. But if I'm cooking it at home, man, I cook the living hell out of it.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Just to make sure. It's the last thing I want.
We were doing swordfish at one of the restaurants I worked at years ago. It was a special, so it was not regularly on the menu. Most of us had not worked with swordfish. Not that difficult to break down. It's not that. But the chef mentioned, hey, man, when you guys break down this swordfish, you're going to see these weird blue things. Sometimes you're going to find these weird little blue things in the flesh, and they kind of look like grubs. We're like, what are they? He's like, they're like blue grubs, man. It's some kind of ocean parasite.
Mm-hmm.
So, man, you know, you're breaking down this fish in the back, and maybe per each steak you cut up, there's like three of these things, but it's almost like that botfly picture.
So even if it was flash frozen, by the time that it thaws, the bugs are still alive.
They're still there. I can't remember if they were alive, but you had to pull them out. I mean, dude, it was so gross, because in the end you realize, like, I understand why we're pulling these out. There's no way we're going to serve this, but I'm pulling a parasite out of this ocean creature, and they're like not a bright blue, but a very intense blue. A little bit darker, but real intense. So your cutting board, right, where you put all your scraps, there's like a pile of these weird blue parasites, man. And I just could not believe that we're still going to serve the fish. But apparently, people that are in the swordfish
love it.
They understand that that's the case. They just don't care.
It is a delicious fish.
Mm-hmm. You know, I never had swordfish, and I think a lot of it is because of just seeing it. When we have like these little tweezers, but you pull these things out, and I'm just like, God, man.
Obviously, they don't have a problem with mercury.
Mm.
What is your personal story involving a bug's life? 206-803-ROCK.
Hello, David. Welcome to the men's room.
Hola.
Hola.
Yeah, my story doesn't involve really any injury, but it's more of a kind of a gross story.
That seems to be the only other option when it comes to bugs.
Yeah. Last year, I was tasked to go visit a prospect. We sell some engineering equipment, so me and my buddy, I'm local, and he's in Austin, Texas, so we met up in Salt Lake City, and we drove 3 hours west on I-80 to a town I'd never been to before. It's like in the middle of nowhere, Nevada, called Elko. And once we get off the freeway, we took these side roads, and I noticed that, you know, a lot of these side roads were like stained, like red. And it's like, well, what's up with this like red stain on the frickin' road? So anyway, we get there and we do our demo, and after that we leave, and then as we're leaving, you know, in the heat, because it was hot, you know, like normally in the heat, when you see a road, you get this kind of like the road's moving in front of you kind of thing?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Well, in this case, it was like red. It was like the road is red and it's moving, and I go, what the hell is going on? Well, in fact, I think we asked the customer prior, it's like, why is this road staying red? And they said, well, there's these things called Mormon crickets. And, okay. So, we basically drove out these side roads, and there were these crickets that are called Mormon crickets, and they're bright red. And I guess that year they had an infestation of them in Nevada, and there's like tens of thousands of them, like just jumping all over the road. And so I found out later that they're cannibalistic, and people just smash them on the road, and then it emits an odor, and it was just gross, just like driving through that. And then later I asked somebody back in Salt Lake, I said, you know, yeah, we ran into these Mormon crickets. And he goes, yeah, you know, funny thing is, you know, our state bird in Utah is the seagull. And I go, why would a seagull be a state bird for Utah? And I guess he said, like, back in the day when the Mormons were settling in Utah, they planted some crops, and they were all devastated by this Mormon cricket, you know, infestation. And then out of nowhere, the seagulls showed up and ate all the crickets. So that became their state bird.
Did you say this was last year that this happened?
Yeah, it was around late August.
I just Googled Mormon crickets, right? Just to get an idea of what they look like. First three things to pop up. Millions of Mormon crickets invade parts of Nevada. Nevada confronts invasion of blood red crickets. Mormon crickets create creepy, crawly nuisance in Elko invasion. Yeah, it was in fact Elko.
Those, yeah. I'm looking at the Elko Daily Free Press.
Oh my God.
Yeah. Oh he's not lying, God. Dude. That, I mean, that's a parking lot, right?
Wow.
You can see the parking. Yeah.
Wow.
Okay. Like, that's awful.
Good times.
Jeez, yeah, you weren't kidding, dude. Yeah, just look at that.
Also, like, I'm not here to defend Mormons either way, but, like, I don't know if we should call it the Mormon cricket. Sounds like they ate all their crops.
I guarantee you the Mormons did not come up with that name.
Yeah, right? Like, why? Don't stick the cricket with us.
Don't name it after us. You can call it the Hungry Mormon Cricket, but do not call it the Mormon Cricket.
It sounds like, yeah, these crickets are bad.
What is your personal story involving a bug's life? 206-803-ROCK.
Hello, Ezra. Welcome to the men's room.
Hola. Can you hear me?
Yes, we can hear you.
Hola.
Okay, good. So when I was younger, I must have been 5 or 6. I'm not quite sure. But we lived in New Mexico. And we was in the desert. Me and my mom and my uncle were trying to get up onto the top of the freeway. And I'm bouncing up and down, crying, trying to figure out why. I kind of find out I am right smack in a pile of red ants. I'm stomping up and down, baby, from head to toe. My mom pulled me up on top of the freeway, took off all my clothes to get them off of me. And so we're hitchhiking back into town. So I'm a cop, you know, picked us up. I'm naked. And he's trying to figure why is you got this kid that is naked on the freeway.
Did anyone eventually pick you guys up?
Pick you up?
Yeah, it was a truck driver who picked us up, took us to town. And he was like, looking at us real funny. Like, what is this kid naked in my truck?
Yeah, that's a big, big risk there.
That is. I don't know if I'd stop to pick you up, Ezra, to be honest with you. I've been just on the side of the road for a long time.
I'd feel bad, but I'd keep going.
I still feel that. I mean, like I said, from head to toe, them things stung. They hurt like I'm like, I can't say the word.
Like, no, we get it, man. I've never heard a good thing about red ants.
No.
And they're what, predominantly southwestern, or is it all the south?
I don't know. I mean, they had there were red ants in West Virginia. Were they technically, they were colored, the red, they were red.
But they weren't fire ants, right?
I don't believe so, no.
Yeah.
But you had different color, black, red, you know, some were both, combination.
I thought those red ants.
Some were bigger, carpenter ants, maybe.
Yeah, we had carpenter ants and rock. They are big-ass ants, but they're not even scary, and they kind of don't bother you other than the fact that we lived in a wood house. And that's the issue. And they call carpenter ants because all they do is eat wood. And this would drive my father crazy, who's like the bug executioner. But I remember he would buy all this crap, right? And because he would go around the house trying to find every little hole that they
burrowed. We had ant traps, like little discs that look like hockey pucks.
Yeah, those ants would pick that thing up, recycle it, and make a car. I mean, these things are massive. So my father would buy all this super hot chemical crap from whatever the local hardware store was, and he blasted it into the hole. And my father could not kill another creature without mentioning that that's what he's doing. And he'd always look at my mom, never me or my brother. It's my mom, like, oh, these ants are going to ant heaven now, right? Real proud. He's all this every time, right? You wait about 5 minutes and you hear my brother yell from downstairs, like, hey, Dad, all the ants are just coming out of a hole down here. So it didn't matter. Right, they just moved. They had holes everywhere. I think we finally got the house fumigated or something like that.
Having ants in a house is tough. And it's not.
And when we get those little sugar ants that they annoy me, but for the most part, just keep the counters clean and they're not too difficult, right?
Crumbs
so
in the
I,
house,
I yeah. get on the kids about that kind of thing. Just keep those things at bay. And for the most part, it works. Well, the carpenter ants, man. I mean, there'll be like 40 of them. They don't want your food. They're eating your house,
right? They're just in there to hang out and eat.
Just in there, yeah. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, those sugar ants. I saw two of them yesterday. Killed them both.
What is your personal story involving a bug's life? 206-803.
The problem with the little sugar ants is I just feel like, I remember as a kid, we had them for, it just seemed like every time you thought it was done,
it's
right?
Never done.
Everything's clean. Everybody's been real strict about it. Mom and Dad have been screaming at you not to leave anything out. And then it's like, yep, you're right. A couple of them show up, and you're like, you got to be kidding me.
They just do. It was literally two of them. So it wasn't like a big emphasis. I'm just trying to make a cup of coffee. And I'm just like, no, guys, come on, man. We've been through this. I am a murderer. Why do you keep rolling into my home?
Apparently, you're not supposed to kill them.
What?
Apparently, when you kill them, they emit some sort of a pheromone that attracts more of them.
That's their plan.
Yes.
You sons of bitches. Man, that sucks. Hello, Zach. Welcome to the men's room.
Hey, how you doing?
Hola.
Hola. Hey, about 25 years ago or so, down in Tacoma, a friend of mine invites her, hey, come on over to my new apartment and we'll go smoke a bowl. Yeah, why not, right? So we go in there, and he goes in the bathroom to go take care of business for a moment. And the only place to sit down is on his bed. It's a little tiny studio. And I'm just looking at the wall, and it's like, man, am I already messed up or something? That wall's like moving. And the problem was the entire wall was moving. I haven't seen a lot of roaches out here except there. It's the only time about one per square centimeter roaches. God. I screamed like a 5-year-old girl and ran right the hell out of there. Oh man.
I've never seen a roach out here.
Well, like I said, I was really surprised to see him. Boy, especially that many. Well, this was right on the harbor, so the place is always kind of damp. I think that's why.
Okay.
But, maybe.
Terrifying. I'm not a roach, yeah, whatever. 30,000 roaches, that's a lot of roaches.
Yeah, I mean, there gets to the point, even things that don't bug me, like snakes don't bother me. But if you put me in a room with 50 of them, let me out of the room.
Right.
And at some point, it's just too much.
Well, you have those two cats, or one cat, I guess, at that point in time. And the fleas were all over those cats. It was indoor, outdoor cat. Mm. But the fleas didn't bite you.
No, they never did.
So I'd come over and sit there.
They'd bite me, too, if I came over.
They were just...
I taught them to not like white people. Oh,
and, man, it's so hard to kill them because you got to kind of pop them.
Like, dude, they're so small.
They don't die.
Yeah. I mean, your fingers, trying to squeeze a flea between your fingers. But it'd be
you pop them, you hear them go... Like, you hear, you've exploded
if
them.
If you can get that far. Otherwise, I feel like it's like dropping a heavy waterbed on them. Like, they're not dead. They're just kind of, warm and stuck.
Tara Daly, Steve Migs coming up from the Daily Migs Morning Show. We will sit and spin. We've got 10 songs about sobriety.
In honor of Dry January coming up. And your emails on the way as well from the men's room at KISW.com.
Imagine the relief of securing fair compensation for an accident you were in, where the insurance companies aren't dictating what's good enough and your injuries and suffering are truly acknowledged. Whether it's an auto accident, a workplace injury, or slip and fall, Phillips Law Firm has dedicated over 2 decades to ensuring their clients receive the rightful compensation and attention they deserve. Call 1-800-JUSTICE today or visit justiceforyou.com. They don't win, you don't pay. Phillips Law Firm, justice for you.
Do relationships have to be easy to be right? Of course not. The best relationships with friends, family, or partners happen when both people put in the time and commitment to make them great. Therapy can help. BetterHelp offers convenient, affordable online therapy. Start the process in minutes and switch therapists anytime. Give your relationship some love with BetterHelp. Visit BetterHelp.com/positive today to get 10% off your first month. That's BetterHelp, HELP.com/positive.
What's up? It's your boy, The Ted Smith from The Men's Room. And did you know I have a podcast? Well, I do. The Podcast. New episodes uploaded every Wednesday on the Odyssey app.
The debauchery rolls on. You're listening to The Men's Room with Miles and Thrill. 99.9. KISW.
In honor of Dry January, we've got 10 songs about sobriety coming up. We'll sit and spin right after emails from the men's room at KISW.com. You got mail. Couple on bugs, man. Bugs really mess people up, didn't they?
Yeah, they do, man.
Unbelievable.
They're tiny little monsters.
Guys, I was a tween. Two of my friends and I were building a forge in the forest. I stepped into a hornet's nest. Got stung on my ankle, freaked out, started running toward my garage door. For some dumb reason, my friends ran through the swamp to escape. So my mom and aunt opened the door to let me in. We closed the bees behind room doors progressively from room to room the best we could, kind of like an airlock. I, the one who stepped in it, got stung once. Both my friends got stung 25 and 40 times. I believe my mom got stung once and my aunt escaped unscathed. Friends really hated me after that. Later found out my aunt was deathly allergic to bee stings and had about 5 minutes to live if she got stung.
Damn. Ooh.
Talk about risking it all for the family. Keep on rocking, guys. That from Terry.
Why did your buddies run through a swamp?
I would run.
My house is here.
Anything flat. Right,
there's a swamp
out
over there. Which way do you want to go to escape? Through the swamp.
I'm afraid of what's in the swamp.
That's what I'm saying.
Where were they running from?
Bees.
Hornets.
Hornets, yeah.
Well, I mean, the swamp has water.
But your house has walls. I'm just saying, given the choice, 9 times out of 10, do you want to run to my house or run through a swamp? Let's run to your house. Mm-hmm. Let's do that.
Yeah. God, man. I had this summer apartment that I was staying in Ocean City, and there was an outdoor shower that was underneath a stairwell. The stairwell went upstairs to the upstairs apartment.
We both units shared the same shower, which was outside on a slab.
Why do they do that?
Underneath the steps, there was lattice around it, but it was an outdoor shower. It's summer. It's not a big deal. The thing about that shower was it was constantly dripping, so there was a lot of moisture in there, and you would go in there, and it was you against 50 mosquitoes.
Mm-hmm.
It did not matter what time of day. It did not matter when you went in there. It was you just fighting off mosquitoes, man. And they were everywhere.
And it's obvious that that's going to be the case, but you don't think about it. The first time we went to Mexico with the kids, you know, they're like 4 and 3 years old.
But that was the shower, not like coming in from the beach, like soap, lathered up.
No, they had an outdoor shower. So there were showers inside of the house we were renting, but they had the outdoor shower. The kids are kids, and you got to make things better for them all the freaking time. So we're like, you know what? Why don't we use the outdoor shower? Right? And they still got their bathing suits on and all that. And they're like, hell yeah. And I thought it was good, man. Same thing. I fired at the water. And basically what I thought was the floor to it just rose up. It's all these mosquitoes. It was my daughter. Yeah, to tuck her under my arm like a football. Just ran into the house. Yeah.
It happened to me in the Outer Banks, but that was different because the house wasn't rented every week. So usually if you have one running water, they don't. But same thing. There was just a little pool of water, so they ain't been in there. So when I turn on that shower, I mean, I remember smacking them, and you could see blood. That's how I knew.
Jesus. Oh, great. In 1980, my new bride and I moved from Wyoming to Indiana in August. We had a really cool cat named Fred who would go on walks with us. One day we were out walking Fred and came across a cicada that had fallen out of a tree. Now, before we could even think, he bites into it, and that thing screams.
Mm-hmm.
I thought my wife was going to faint, barf, and scream with it, or maybe all the above. One of the best laughs I've had in 43 and a half years.
I forgot about
of
that.
Of marriage.
Cicadas, they do scream, and the first year I'd experienced them, I think I was about 18, 19. I remember I had a magazine in my hand, and like I said, they fly real clumsily. And I just swung the magazine and hit this thing. Right? It didn't kill it, but just hit it, and you get a good, because they're hard-shelled thing. And yeah, same thing. This thing, I was like, oh my God, I feel bad, man. Yeah.
Abu bitches, I sprayed a bee's nest at night. The next day, I went out to take a look at it. It was under my walkway in the corner of my eave. I walked slowly up to it because it was still a little bit of activity, I could tell. Well, this son of a bitch darted right for my lip. It bit me or stung me on the bottom lip, outside and inside, while inside two times on my tongue. And as I tried to grab it and grasp it under my upper lip. Damn. And it got me two times there. Six times, this guy got me. My mouth and tongue were swollen. I couldn't eat anything for a week and had to drink out of a straw. I felt like I came home from the dentist for like a week there. That from Doug. Guys, my best friend went on a Peace Corps mission in 1982 in Zaire, Africa. He was fishing in a river, reached down between his cheeks, pulled out a worm, and baited his hook. That from Bob in Orchard Island.
Nope. Do not share that story again.
Hola, guys. Cockroaches can, in fact, bite. I was staying in New Mexico in a VRBO. In the middle of the night, I rolled over and felt a pinching on the back of my thigh. I shot straight up out of bed and flung the covers off, turned on the light, and saw this little effing cockroach. I grabbed the nearest thing to me, a book, and smashed the hell out of it. But I couldn't sleep the rest of the night. That from Mindy. As we move on to the birthday shout-outs, liquor and whores, guys, my name is, today is my brother-in-law, Andrew, a.k.a. Buddy's 23rd birthday. Can you guys give me your penises too small, a fart, and the dirty Germans talking about what he's going to do on his golden birthday? Love you, man, from Court and your big sis, Tay.
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah, I don't know about you, but each year I like to do a themed birthday party. So if this is your golden birthday, I say you have a shower.
Yeah, so I was going to say, whoever he's having intimate time with will probably be in a rain jacket tonight.
Yeah, he'll be like, no, I have two more shots. We're going to make this fun.
Yeah, tonight we both wear a raincoat.
Yeah, whatever you do, drink light beer.
Hola, guys, can I please get a birthday shout-out to my friend Lauren? Birthday is today. He's turning 33, heading into the nitty-gritty of his dirty 30s. How about a Leroy Jenkins? Your penis is too small. And the dirty Germans talking about fishing. You all are amazing. Thank you so much. That from a fan for a fan, Chloe.
Let's do this. Leroy Jenkins!
Yeah, it's funny you bring up fishing because I've got new ideas since an email just 2 minutes ago. I plan on pulling a worm out from between my cheeks and using it as bait.
Yeah, there's so many fun things, like it's a man in the boat.
Yeah.
Right? Just maybe I could tie you up with some of the string. Depends on how heavy the test line is.
Yeah.
And boo bitches, today is the day I've been looking forward to since I was about 10 years old. Today isn't just my birthday. Today I am the answer to the ultimate question. To life, the universe,
42.
And everything. Today I turned 42 years old.
All right.
Why 42?
Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy, the book series. So the idea was they created a super duper 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 double smart ridiculous computer, right? And all they said is, what is the answer to, what is it, life, the universe, and everything? A computer says 42. And they said, well, what does that mean? The computer basically, yeah. You asked the wrong question, but the answer to the question you asked, 42.
Okay.
Oh, by the way, guys, the party's in Bremerton, and there's some brisket left.
Ooh.
So can I get an oh, look out, and Al hitting the window, and a Jeb Bush, please clap. Thanks, fellas. That from Better Than Ezra.
Oh, look out.
Please clap.
Oh, Jeb, I forget about him.
All right, guys, Here you go. Happy, happy, happy birthday. Happy, happy, happy birthday. Happy, happy, happy birthday to you, to you, to you.
Yaws of Dirty Germans, brought to you by Men's Room Original Sausage. Available through Uli's World Famous Sausage, mensroomlive.com, and other fine retailers. Schweineflash.
Yes, friends, it's time once again for Sit and Spin. Let's gather around the old radio and listen to some swellerific new music.
Third Daily, Steve Miggs from the Daily Miggs Morning Show. How's it going?
What's up, fellas?
Oh, you know, we're living life here.
You look great. You look great.
Thanks. We feel great.
Hey, sun's out.
Yeah, that's right.
Sun's out, guns.
Guns out, Ted. Look at this.
At least for a little bit today.
More like you a guys, buns out kind of guy, personally.
That's why he wears chaps.
I say skies out, thighs out. Get those short shorts on, you know?
Yeah. That's a good time.
I mean,
time
you,
of
not
year.
Me. I'm not going to wear short shorts. You guys go ahead.
Taryn, how are you doing getting up in the morning?
You don't even own shorts.
I don't.
You seriously don't own shorts?
Well, I mean, like, I have like two shorts, but they're like a tasteful length for moms.
Oh, God. I don't wear shorts very much. And then one time Ted cornered me and actually said, hey, what's wrong with you? And I'm like, what are you talking about? He's like, what's the deal, man? And I'm like, what does that even mean? He says, how come you're not wearing shorts? Because it was like during the summer. I'm just like, I didn't know that this was a thing.
Yeah, Ryan Castle doesn't wear shorts unless he's running.
Maybe this will be the summer of shorts for us, Steve.
There you go.
I hope summer gets here. Shorts. Meanwhile, we're in January. I have never heard of this before. Have you guys ever heard of a concept called, they call it dry January?
I've heard the term, but it does not register in my mind that it's something that should exist.
I looked it up to find out what it meant.
I did dry January one time, but it was because I was pregnant with my son. So
you did more than a pregnant dry January.
I did a dry pregnancy. It was wonderful.
A dry pregnancy.
Okay. So though that's commitment. I mean, once it you really find is. Out, whatever your fun is, your fun's gone. For
it's
a while.
Over.
So and you guys get downright miserable. Yeah. My wife, I mean, like, you know, they said, hey, you can have like two or three glasses of wine, and you don't have to cut it all out. She cut out everything. Yeah, and basically, as soon as that kid popped out, it's like, I want a martini.
So I'm sure what you did was you went in and just pumped like, you know, like an oil rig, so that you would have a
that's pump February.
You'd have a stockpile.
Yes.
So you could get hammered, right?
So you could go out and get hammered, and then you pump and dump.
Right. You pump and dump. How drunk?
Or you save that the one that you pump and dump. You save that and it's sleepy time milk.
Okay. Ah, yes.
I'm kidding. I didn't do that.
Or sell it on the internet like I did.
But after 7 or 8 months of not having a beverage, how hammered did you get?
I had, so like the seltzer craze was like just kind of coming up. I had one seltzer and I was like, whoa! I mean, really? I felt wasted off of one seltzer. I'm like, what is this, 4%?
How about, crazy. And you could get stoned, so I'm sure the same thing then.
Oh, yeah. Everything was, it was a lot. Yeah, it was a lot. But guess what? My tolerance is back to normal.
All right. Okay. I do know one person that attempted dry January this year. I believe she said it was $500, right? She's doing it with a bunch of other people. Made it 12 days.
Wow.
12 days.
12 days. Oh, yeah.
Well, my birthday's in January, so I never want to have a dry January.
No, don't.
I can say with complete confidence that no one in this room, the four of you guys, have never done dry January.
No. Well, yeah. New Year's Day is football.
Right.
So we have the day off.
I've done a January before.
I was
going to
say, you definitely blew me off on my birthday one time.
Yeah. Mike's done one before.
I'm in the middle of it right now.
Yeah.
Oh, really? You're alive. Okay, all right. Okay, so we do have one person in here.
Oh, that was a challenge.
He's actually trying.
I didn't want to sell you out, because Lord knows Miles is going to stay on him now. Come on, Mike. Get on.
Have a little
sip. Just one sip.
Just one. Little nip.
That's right. So we're going to celebrate sobriety today on Sit and Spin. We have 10 songs about sobriety in honor of dry January.
Number 10. On the Sunday morning sidewalk.
See, this is why people drink, so they don't write crap like this.
Is this Sunday morning coming down?
Sure is.
I don't think this is about being sober.
Well, it's about the after effects of feeling like ass and you're coming down from, yeah, you're not feeling so good.
So you're not actively you're messed up, but you were messed up yesterday. Over.
Yes, at 2 o'clock, you were drunk. It's 6 a.m., you feel like ass.
I thought there was part of that song he talks about getting back on it.
Well, I think everyone thinks about that.
It's the same.
Right.
What's he? Can't get hungover if you hang on, Taryn?
Oh, no. Yeah. Why hang over when you can hang on?
There you go. These are 10 songs about sobriety on Sit and Spit.
Number nine.
Again, not motivation.
No.
That's almost annoying.
This will haunt you the rest of your life. Yeah.
It's Jason Isbell and the 400 unit, of course.
Okay.
Yeah.
Don't think about the Jack Daniels you love so much in the beer. Late nights being young and drinking Mad Dog. Don't even think about any of that.
You got this. 10 songs about sobriety.
Eight. Number eight.
Tonight, the bottle.
This makes me want to drink.
It really sounds like a drinking song.
I mean, he sounds drunk.
Right.
It's Merle. Right, the bottle let me down.
I mean, it, sometimes it does.
Sometimes the bottle lifts you up.
I want to know what inspired the song then. Like, at what point did he look at this? I need to write a song about how the bottle just let me down. Because I feel like it probably let me down a lot.
It's the bottle. It's the bottle's fault.
It's the bottle's fault. Not my actions.
No.
That's why I swore off filling here.
Yeah, exactly. 10 songs about sobriety.
Number seven.
Passenger side. Passenger side.
It's Wilco. Passenger side.
That's where you can drink. I'm not driving off.
Exactly. That's what I was thinking. Like, I'm behind the wheel would be the one I'd ride.
You notice none of these are upbeat.
No, these are depressing as all hell.
Like in the hair metal days when they're drinking and doing drugs, like, it's all real upbeat music. This makes it depressing to me.
Yeah, because these are all next day.
That's what it
is. Yeah, it's not fun spraying whiskey on somebody the next day.
Wait until the next Thursday to make another song.
We're
partying again.
Shame.
It's 10 a.m. on a Sunday. I don't want a champagne shower, lady.
You got the Advil bottle up to your lips, shaking it in your mouth.
The bottle's fault.
10 songs about sobriety.
Number six.
I've been a massive Weezer fan my entire life. I had no idea what this song was about until right now.
I was today years old as well when I learned that information.
So what's going on about that?
Is he something about his father, dear mother, dear father? I don't even know the lyrics.
Yeah, what the hell? Are we sure he's talking about sobriety?
I thought he just got a sweater stolen all the time. Who knew?
The lists do not lie, gentlemen. The lists do not lie.
Oh, that's a very fair point. Very fair point.
10 songs about sobriety on Sit and Spin.
Five. Number five.
Well, yeah.
This would be number one.
What does he do in his spare time? Produce wine.
Yeah. Well, he can't be sober. That's why he's asking why.
Yeah, that's actually a good point. I keep drinking this wine.
He's got to spell it out.
It's all in how you look at the question.
Right. I'm not saying I'm sober. I'm saying why can't I be sober?
These are 10 songs about sobriety.
Four, number four.
I'm a sucker for 90s Aerosmith, I'm not going to lie.
How are they in a position to write about sobriety?
Come on, man.
Crap, is Joe Perry in the room?
It's rock and roll, man. You ever talk to Joe Perry?
No, but I heard your guys'
interview. Oh, my God. We had no idea.
It's like if Sylvester Stallone were on Novocaine.
Joan Jett, rock and roll.
What happened?
Yeah, Joan Jett was another one that surprised me. What? What is happening?
I want a cheeseburger. I'm a French fry. I'm Joe Jett. I'm old champ.
10 songs about sobriety.
Number three. Now you live
inside again, let's consider the source. At this time, during Ozzy's like, bro, you're talking to me about sobriety. I'm going to recruit you to the Klan. I mean, come on. There's certain things that you just have to assume are not true.
Wait, because this is what? 1980?
This is like
snorting
like era.
Yeah. Right.
Peak Ozzy.
He's the worst source.
Got a mullet. never wears a shirt. Right.
10 songs about sobriety.
Number two.
You're living a dream, though you on top. My mind is aching alone.
He's the guy you beat up at the campfire.
That's how Stevie Ray Vaughan.
Yep.
Yeah.
When it got notorious,
he's actually foreshadowing EDM DJs. I mean, Life by the Drop.
I've never seen any footage of Stevie Ray Vaughan where he wasn't just violently sweating like he just did an entire week. I'm serious. I mean, look at any. I know he played in Texas a lot, but still, anywhere he played, man, he's just dripping. It's amazing he can hold on to the goddamn guitar.
Yeah, let's call it drugs and booze, kids. That's
10 songs about sobriety.
Number one.
Another real banger.
God, man. He sounds drunk.
He does.
So does the drummer.
Yeah, right.
Drummer must be hot.
The Kinks, alcohol. Yeah, that's a real...
It sounds like your drunk roommate in the shower. You know what I mean? It's like, come on, Phil, hurry up, man.
Alcohol. Great.
Wow.
Daily Migs, 6 to 10 weekday mornings right here at 99.9 KISW.
Cheers.
Guys are kicking ass.
Thank you.
Really tomorrow morning, Joe Perry and Joan Jett.
Oh, boy.
I would pay money to listen to that.
Yeah, if you're celebrating a dry January, we got the shot of the day coming up. You are listening to The Men's Room.
Maximize the compensation for your injury claim with Phillips Law Firm. With over 80 years of combined legal experience, they won't allow the insurance companies to dictate what's good enough for you. Whether it's an auto accident or workplace injury, contact Phillips Law Firm today. If they don't win, you don't pay.
Shall I take your order, or do you need a minute?
Yes, I'll be ready. Just buying a car on Carvana.
What?
It's super convenient. I already got pre-qualified in 2 minutes. All I had to do was answer a few questions.
What? That's handy.
Yeah, now I'm customizing my down and monthly payments.
What? That's an exquisite deal.
And just like that, Carvana's delivering my car in a couple days.
What?
Oh, yeah. Sorry, I'll have the burrito.
Visit Carvana.com to finance your next car.
Financing subject to credit approval. Delivery fees may apply.
1, 2, 3, 4. Those are numbers, but you already knew that. If you want to know what number you're going to pay each month for your car, use Kelley Blue Book My Wallet on AutoTrader. They're really good at numbers. AutoTrader.
When it comes to clothes, having pieces that you can wear anywhere is a must. That's why American Giant makes clothing that fits your life seamlessly, with quality you have to feel to believe. Whether you're stocking up for any weather or picking up a special gift, you'll find an impressive selection of staples to choose from. So whether you're on the hunt for a heavyweight hoodie, a fleece jacket, or a hard-working pair of warm sweatpants, American Giant has what you're looking for. Each American Giant piece is designed to last and created with commitment to doing things better. And all their products are made right here in America. Because keeping things local ensures the kind of quality you'll feel and appreciate for years to come. Discover the American Giant difference today. Shop Wear Anywhere Closet Staples at American-Giant.com and get 20% off your order when you use code ANYSTYLE24 at checkout. That's 20% off at American-Giant.com, promo code ANYSTYLE24.
99.9 KISW. The shenanigans continue. This is the Men's Room with Miles and Thrill.
All right, so come on, Mets. We'll drink ourselves with the shot of the day. And we do have your headlines on the way at 5:50. But first, quick check with Mike Hawk and some of the stories and headlines he is not working on.
Thank you, Miles. A school in North Carolina removed its bathroom mirrors to stop kids from making TikToks.
Why?
I don't know.
Look. They're not cutting class. They're not being late for school. They're not just during the break in class. They make TikToks. You know what kids do? They make TikToks.
Exactly.
That's it. And Mike, I told you earlier, the things I... Now, listen.
I was about to say, we did such worse things in the bathroom when we were kids, and then you had something interesting.
I'm not going to repeat it here, but man, it was funny. But we would do it all the time, but the point was, it was the same amount of time, right?
Right.
3-5 minutes during class, whatever. And what we did, because we had idle hands, was bad. At least with TikTok, when they get 15 follows, they're happy. Who cares?
Exactly.
They're not doing
And they're stupid anything. Little dances. It's not like they're, you know, bearing it all in the mirror or something like that.
That was actually the first time I experienced TikTok. I had never heard of TikTok years ago. And We were on the East Coast visiting family at Christmas, and one of my nieces, I didn't know she had a phone propped up in the window. She's standing in the living room facing sideways doing like this hand dance.
Mm-hmm.
And I finally just asked her, I said, are you having a seizure? Like, what is wrong with you? What are you doing? She goes, I'm making a TikTok. Like, what the hell is that TikTok? And she points at her phone, explains what it is. Then I dance with her, and she got more likes.
There it is.
And I know it's because I sucked at dancing.
Younger generations bringing
who's
in older generations.
Who's the dumbass in the background?
Plus, it's like, they're kids. Like, they're going to waste time in that bathroom either way. You can take out the mirrors. They're still going to waste time in that.
Right. And don't worry. They don't need the mirror to make the TikTok.
Yeah, good point.
It made it easier. You don't need it. Like, relax. Relax. Just because you don't get it doesn't mean it's bad.
Kraft is releasing three new flavors of their singles. Ted, are you ready?
Wait, there was caramelized onion.
That's one.
Yep.
Garlic and herb. Jalapeno. Garlic and herb is two, and jalapeno.
Jalapeno, okay.
I mean, I'm in.
Are you?
Yeah. Honestly, it'd make great grilled cheese. Jalapeno grilled cheese.
I read a review on MASH, and they said that they were fine. They're just bland.
It's Kraft singles.
Oh, exactly. I was like, what did you expect? That's exactly what I thought, Mike.
That's why I'm like, I feel like if you need flavored cheese, you got to step up from the American cheese.
Yeah, I do.
Okay. But it's still...
And you can buy a jalapeno cheddar. You know, a block of that.
But sure. I think that's why they're like, look, we're the cheaper version of what we realize you're spending money on the buy.
Yeah. All right. It's like saying McDonald's has a new burger coming out. Like, okay, I know what I expect.
And I think part of it is you can ease your kids into trying other foods, right?
Yeah.
We're adults, so Kraft Singles, we know what we're going to expect. But like something like my daughter, like, hey, baby, it's a Kraft American single slice, which to her is equivalent of saying, I don't know, an oath to God that this must be good. This is a different flavor, but it's from the people that you have loved from Kraft. They won't steer you wrong. I guarantee you, she'll like all three of those, not try a legitimate cheese of the same flavor.
One of my favorite dad things was waking up in the morning, not necessarily getting my kids breakfast before they went to school, but making them their lunch.
Sure.
Singles are always a part of that.
Oh, like, yeah.
If I had turkey, if I had ham,
they get excited.
As long as I had a Kraft single on there, man. So to me, it's kind of like for that and for melting things. And you know.
Oh, I always have them in the fridge for certain things. I like them on breakfast sandwiches. And you're right. I'll still make a turkey sandwich once in a while and just like screw up putting the American cheese.
Yeah, if you have Swiss, use that. But
an animal shelter in Rhode Island is offering to bury your ex's name in one of their litter boxes to be defecated on by their cats.
Oh, that'll get them.
I think it's funny.
How bitter are you?
It's funny, but it's you go, hey, man, just be done with this. If you're at the point that this seems like a good idea,
time to get over it.
Yeah, that's all. That's all. I think the offer is fine. The idea is funny. It's not bad. But if you personally are at that point, like, take a deep breath, move forward.
Yeah, you're not fully wrong there. Gentlemen, all day we were talking about bug encounters, and let's face it, they were not exactly what I'd call fun. And in fact, some of them might have even spurred some phobias. And that got me thinking, how many other phobias do we have? Let's see what we can do.
The Men's Room Top 10. The Men's Room Top 10
common animal phobias. I bet there's one that's not on this list, and it's one of the most fearsome and ferocious creatures you'll ever come across. Unlike other members of this animal kingdom, this desperate, wild beast can be found late at night, often carousing around dens of iniquity. I present to you Ilorophobia. That is the fear of the cougar. You'll be able to spot her subtle characteristics. Smoker's cough. A dirty, dirty martini. Three or more olives. And sequins. Steer clear, friends.
Outdid yourself that
Smoker's
one.
Smoker's cough. That is a good one.
I didn't see that one coming.
That might have been one of your best ones ever.
So what I have here is I have the 10 most common animal phobias. And I actually have the name of the phobia. These are all very common. These are not kind of outlandish, you know, do you have a fear of ostriches? Like, this is...
Give us the phobia name, see if we can guess.
Exactly. So at
go
number
back
10,
to your inner Latin.
Well, I'm guessing by today, there has to be arachnophobia on the list.
Wait for it, Miles. Okay. Wait for it. We have cynophobia. C-Y-N-O, cynophobia.
C-Y-N-O.
Yep.
And is it phobia of an animal, or are they just phobias in general?
C-Y-N-O. No, this is a phobia of an animal. These are all animal phobias. Very common. Usually when you meet these people, it's like, really? Did you have a bad encounter? What happened?
Dogs.
The fear of dogs.
Yep.
Absolutely. I knew somebody that had a fear of dogs because they were mauled by a dog when they were a kid.
All right. Well, that makes sense.
My daughter had a big fear of dogs for a while. One, because she's just overly dramatic. So you know what we did? I got a dog.
Got a dog.
Oh, yeah. I was like...
It helped me. I was afraid of bigger dogs because, when you're a kid, well, shoot, half the dogs that are out there are your size. They're these big old beasts just walking around. And you're just kind of hoping that they don't kill you.
Yeah, she's not scared of dogs anymore. And even when I told her, she's like, why did you get a dog if you don't scared of dogs? I said, get you scared of dogs. I'm tired of hearing about it. This is your dog. Meet Molly. Molly, this is my daughter. Now you're fine.
Best and, Mike, I'm with you. Most of my friends that say they don't like dogs... Like, they either got bit as a kid or, like, something happened.
My brother, not a fan of dogs.
Correct,
He's been killed by every dog that's ever met him other than my current one.
That is weird.
Still alive.
It is weird.
Number nine.
He knew he was going to grow up to be a ref.
He's the banana to the bee. You know, there's something about him where dogs are like, kill that man.
At number nine, herpetophobia. H-E-R-P, reptiles. The fear of reptiles. Yep.
Coming up on Big Dummy, I'm guessing.
No, but as a result of Big Dummy, HERPA, you guys want to think herpes, and I think they came up with the term herpes and herpetology because when you get herpes, it looks like reptile skin.
Really?
Okay. Right? So, herpes.
That's
right?
What Steve told me.
I don't believe I have a fear of reptiles. I don't trust them all that much.
I don't have a fear of reptiles, but it depends on the reptile. I am not scared of snakes. Here's a crocodile. Okay, I have an issue.
Right.
It's such a broad statement. Mm. It depends on the reptile.
See, I'm with you, because I have a phobia of snakes, but like my buddy had a caiman, and I used to love watching that thing.
Right?
At number eight, this one's going to be hard, scolesophobia. Scolesophobia. S-C-O-L-E-C. Scolesophobia. Now, this one's uncommon because you don't really see these animals, and it's one of those quote-unquote animals. It might be technically an insect. The fear of worms.
Ah, my mom has that.
Back to me cooking my salmon.
Especially parasitic worms.
Well, that's what I'm saying. So I cook my salmon well done.
Exactly.
Now, my mom is terrified of worms, but she loves gardening. As a child, it drove me crazy.
That is kind of crazy that she likes gardening that much and hates worms.
They aerate the soil. You need them.
I tried to explain this to my mother, but I mean, every year for about 9 years when I'm living with them, I would hear her scream. It's a Saturday morning. You're all from school and you want to sleep in. And she was paralyzed. And I'd have to go out there, grab worms, and I'd just always throw them over the fence at the neighbor's yard.
Yeah.
And I kept telling her, stop gardening if you don't like worms, because you know where they live, where you garden.
That's right. 10 common animal phobias. This one's a very broad one, but it's agrizoophobia.
Agrizoophobia.
Is this a fear of going to the zoo?
No.
Not angry animals?
It is the fear of wild animals.
Okay, yeah. All right,
that's fair.
Which I kind of get behind. When I see an animal out in the wild, other than like a deer or something like that, I don't know how to behave around you. I don't know if what I am doing is going to offend you, if it's going to set you off. I would love to just look at you from all the way over here. And I'd love a good amicable, interaction here.
Is it phobia or is that common sense?
Yeah, that's fair.
If it is a wild animal and it can take you out, I think you exercise caution.
Right.
As much as I love dogs, if there's a big dog just running down my street or my parking lot, even I'm kind of like, all right, this seems off.
Give it a minute.
Because now it's like, it's on its own, it's loose, what's going on?
Right.
Yeah, fair.
Ranidophobia.
Ranidophobia.
R-A-N-I-D-A. Ranidophobia. It's,
thanks for spelling. It's really helping, Mike.
Hey, just in case, man, I know you know your Latin roots. I'm just trying to help you all the way there. This is an amphibious animal that we don't see a whole lot of around here, but they are out here. Frogs. Fear of frogs.
They're just ugly and weird looking, but they're... Yeah.
Exactly.
Can frogs freeze like the iguanas and come back to life?
Yes.
Yes, I believe so. Yep.
Thank God.
They stick their head up.
Thank God, Ted. That's what I said.
I was putting on a golf course once, and there was a giant frog just sitting there, but it was like frozen. And I just looked at my buddy and said, let's get off this green.
They had a huge freeze in Florida last couple
days. Yeah.
And all the alligators have their nose out, and they're in a frozen pond, but the only thing sticking up is their nose.
Yep, so they can breathe.
Out of the frozen water.
We'll be back.
The basis of our question today, entomophobia.
Insects.
The fear of insects, absolutely. How about musophobia?
Musa?
Muso.
Mice?
Correct.
The fear of mice. M words.
I just realized this, you know, in the last few years. I apparently have a fear of mice.
Really?
Do you scream?
I don't.
That means you do. Don't say you don't. You know. If you're scared of something, you scream. But why mice? What is it about them that bugs you?
Because they move very fast. They carry a bunch of parasites. They appear in places, and they're gross. I don't like it. I know that I can take them out. I know that they're small. I have taken one out before in my life. It was a traumatic experience.
But they're faster than you.
But also, it's not so much mice as much the rats. I remember living in Sumner. There's a big old dumpster out there, throwing my garbage out there, and you lift that lid, and there's this big son of a gun just staring his eyes right at me. And I'm afraid he's going to jump at me. No, he's not going to do a whole lot of damage, but I don't want it.
We are the only creature on Earth. I truly believe this. This is not scientific. I believe that we are the only human beings, only creature on Earth, where in spite of the fact that we will dominate, kill, and crush you, burn down your home, and chase you out of town, we just don't want you to touch us.
That's right. Right? Just don't touch me.
If it's you against a rat, you win 100% of the time.
Oh, yeah.
You rip its head off, crush it, stomp it.
But I don't want to go through
Right. Where every other animal's like, I don't care what I have to go through. If we're fighting life to death, bro, let's go.
They wear their battle scars.
I feel like your cat would take on a mouse if one got in your
house. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, you're fine.
Yeah. The only thing I'm worried about there is the parasites that it would ingest after it ate the damn thing.
You got to remember, cats don't take on anything. They play with them.
They do.
Torture them.
He's a psycho. He's a psycho.
If they can find where they went.
They want to play with them first, then kill them.
10 common animal phobias. Sphexophobia.
Sphexo?
S-P-H-E-K. Sphexophobia. It's another one that came up today. It is the fear, and rightly so, of wasps.
Ah, okay. Yeah, they hurt.
Right. Especially if you've got anaphylaxis.
I feel like wasps and bees and hornets are different, right? You can fear cockroaches. They're not going to do anything to you. You don't want the creepy quality nature.
Right.
You can have a fear of mice. Maybe it's parasite, but they're not going to do anything to you. A wasp, you're like, no. I fear this because it freaking hurts.
They have an army,
man,
and are all tuned in to attack you.
Dude, killer bees freak me the hell out.
Much different. Oh, yeah.
The top two are not going to shock you, but number two would be arachnophobia. We hear about it all the time. That is the fear of spiders.
That's the recognition that spiders are alien creatures here to dominate and kill us through painful means.
But then the number one most common animal phobia, a lot of people have it, including one of our very own, ophidiophobia.
Snakes?
The fear of snakes. Don't overthink it. It's the fear of snakes. Why, Ted?
I mean, I think, number one, you hear all the stories about the snake, the serpent making Eve eat the apple.
Of course.
But it wasn't mean. He just said, have a meal.
The snake dropping out of the tree once when I was a kid. That's probably not good.
So it's more of a traumatic experience as opposed to any
biblical
kind of just
implications.
Willy feeling that you get.
I don't know. Yeah. I just don't. You know what I mean? Look, it's a phobia.
Yeah.
I'm trying to give reasons. I don't know.
It's a phobia.
It's irrational fear. I don't like them.
By nature, by definition. A woman in California was arrested for being the biggest fan of the latest craze, Miles.
What is the latest craze?
Give you all the details at 550.
Thank you, sir. Headlines are coming up at 550. In the meantime, let's get a contestant online for profile. That's a 206-803-ROCK. Already made it to drinking time.
Imagine the relief of securing fair compensation for an accident you were in, where the insurance companies aren't dictating what's good enough and your injuries and suffering are truly acknowledged. Whether it's an auto accident, a workplace injury, or slip and fall, Phillips Law Firm has dedicated over two decades to ensuring their clients receive the rightful compensation and attention they deserve. Call 1-800-JUSTICE today or visit justiceforyou.com. They don't win, you don't pay. Phillips Law Firm. Justice for you.
Do relationships have to be easy to be right? Of course not. The best relationships with friends, family, or partners happen when both people put in the time and commitment to make them great. Therapy can help. BetterHelp offers convenient, affordable online therapy. Start the process in minutes and switch therapists anytime. Give your relationship some love with BetterHelp. Visit BetterHelp.com/positive today to get 10% off your first month. That's BetterHelp, HELP.com/positive.
Okay, picture this. It's Friday afternoon when a thought hits you. I can spend another weekend doing the same old whatever, or I can hop into my all-new Hyundai Santa Fe and hit the road. With available H-Track all-wheel drive and three-row seating, my whole family can head deep into the wild. Conquer the weekend in the all-new Hyundai Santa Fe. Visit HyundaiUSA.com or call 562-314-4603 for more details. Hyundai, there's joy in every journey. 2024 Santa Fe, available early 2024.
Get ahead of postage rate increases this year with Stamps.com. It's like your own personal post office. Sign up with promo code PROGRAM for a 4-week trial plus free postage and a free digital scale. No long-term commitments or contracts. That's Stamps.com, code PROGRAM.
Imagine the relief of securing fair compensation for an accident you were in, where the insurance companies aren't dictating what's good enough and your injuries and suffering are truly acknowledged. Whether it's an auto accident, a workplace injury, or slip and fall, Phillips Law Firm has dedicated over 2 decades to ensuring their clients receive the rightful compensation and attention they deserve. Call 1-800-JUSTICE today or visit justiceforyou.com. They don't win, you don't pay. Phillips Law Firm. Justice for you.
Oh, should we start this show?
Yeah, I'm down. Just buying a car on Carvana first.
Oh, for real?
Yeah, it's super convenient. I already got pre-qualified in 2 minutes. All I had to do is answer a few questions.
Ooh, that's helpful.
And now just customizing my down and monthly payments.
Ooh, that's a very fair deal.
Yep. Boom. Just bought a car. And you get to take me to the Carvana vending machine in a couple days to pick it up.
Ooh.
I'm kind of busy.
Visit Carvana.com to finance your next car.
Financing subject to credit approval.
What's up? It's your boy, The Ted Smith from The Men's Room. And did you know I have a podcast? Well, I do. The Podcast. New episodes uploaded every Wednesday on the Odyssey app.
Somebody out there deserves to be recognized. And the men's room knows just who it is. So to you, we say, bottoms up, sailor. You're the toast of our shot of the day.
Big time it is, and as usual, we head to the drink desk and Steve and Thrill Hill to find out who we're toasting.
Yes, indeed. And today we toast 75-year-old Michael Wisberix Sr. of Punta Gorda, Florida. Now, in the pre-dawn hours, Michael started rummaging through a docked boat. The problem was that it was not his boat, and the owner of the actual boat was asleep on said boat. Now, after being called to the scene, the boat's owner told police that an older man was caught on the boat's cameras rifling through their belongings. And police confirmed the accusations by reviewing the footage. Now, what they discovered was that Michael, he didn't actually steal anything. He didn't. It looked like he wanted to. He went through the stuff. He chose to take nothing. Now, that's a good thing. He did, however, leave behind an additional piece of evidence. And that evidence was his excrement. For some reason, he pooped on the boat. Now, oddly enough, Michael didn't really leave the scene of the crime. Cops found him sitting nearby on a bench at the marina. And that's when they realized that Michael had also pooped on the dock as well, and he was arrested. They did not say what the charges were. I'm curious. Maybe trespassing. Definitely no theft. He didn't take anything. But he pooped in 2 different locations. I get the feeling he'll be out soon.
Pooping on the dock of the bay.
Pooping on the dock of the bay.
Sure, Otis loves that.
I ate some chili, but things weren't going my way. So we pour this booze and we drink this booze because we think it's yummy.
Yummy!
So over the tongue and down the throat to party in our tummies.
Down the hola, bitchola!
The men's room presents Profile This.
Hey, Stephen Thrill Hill, could you please serve everyone out? Profile This is played.
I sure can, Miles. It's a simple game where we share with you a real life news story, something that happened right here on planet Earth. And as you listen to the story, based on the stereotypes you believe to be true of people and the decisions that people make, we'll ask you what it is you think makes the story a story. Our caller has since dropped off. Thank you for calling in. So the three of you will be playing. We have 3 categories. We have the wonderful world of drugs. We have bite me. In other words, what did someone find in their food? And finally, interior decorating, where you guessed the foreign object that ended up on the inside of someone.
All right, Miles, pick one.
Let's go bite me.
Just eat it. Eat it. Get yourself an egg and beat it.
All right, here's the story. A McDonald's restaurant in Columbus, Ohio was temporarily closed after a couple found something unusual in their food order. An anonymous male customer ordered breakfast from the drive-thru at McDonald's. The man says that when he and his girlfriend went to consume their food, they found the surprise. According to the Columbus Dispatch newspaper, they report that the customer chronicled his experience on Reddit. He explained that after making the discovery, he approached the location's manager, who did, in fact, offer him a refund. Now, the customer noted, that he brought the surprise to the location's attention so that a similar instance would not occur in the future. Additionally, he forwarded his complaint to the Columbus Public Health Department. The health department did arrive at the store, and they closed the location for an emergency health inspection the following day. The officials found multiple health code violations prompted by an on-site construction. All right. So repairs, they were being conducted on the restaurant's seating area, front service counter, and beverage station. But additionally, construction workers moved freely to the food prep and customer seating areas. Construction equipment, debris, and trash were also found throughout the location. All of that in mind, what did the man find in his breakfast? By the way, Ted, before you ask, I do not know specifically what he ordered.
What's that, what you was?
But I always know that's your thought.
No, it's my thought, too.
So the question is, what did he find in the sandwich? Was it a nail, a tape measure, a cigarette butt, or a crack pipe? So a nail, tape measure, a cigarette butt, or crack pipe. One of these four things was found in his breakfast meal.
What was the last one?
Okay, the paper.
Crack pipe.
Crack pipe.
Nail, tape measure, cigarette butt, or crack pipe.
Okay. I'm going to go construction-wise, cigarette butt there, Ted.
How messed up was he?
What do you mean?
When he bit into it?
He opened it and saw you. He did not bite into it, did not consume it, did not eat it. He just opened it and said, you got to be kidding me. Come on, man.
If that's the case, I think that this is incredibly outlandish, and I think that there is a tape measure in that.
Tape measure?
In that,
okay. Sample.
I agree it's outlandish, but I think, you know, I guess I'm just picking crack pipe all week so far.
Crack pipe.
Eventually, it's got to hit if they're still in there.
You just play the odds.
Yeah.
What was in his breakfast? Was it a nail, a tape measure, a cigarette butt, or a crack pipe? We'll find out next.
Oh, you son of mother. God damn it. Hang on. No, I'm going to do this, Mike.
That was a tease.
Imagine the relief of securing fair compensation for an accident you were in. Where the insurance companies aren't dictating what's good enough and your injuries and suffering are truly acknowledged. Whether it's an auto accident, a workplace injury, or slip and fall, Phillips Law Firm has dedicated over two decades to ensuring their clients receive the rightful compensation and attention they deserve. Call 1-800-JUSTICE today or visit justiceforyou.com. They don't win, you don't pay. Phillips Law Firm. Justice for you.
Do relationships have to be easy to be right? Of course not. The best relationships with friends, family, or partners happen when both people put in the time and commitment to make them great. Therapy can help. BetterHelp offers convenient, affordable online therapy. Start the process in minutes and switch therapists anytime. Give your relationship some love with BetterHelp. Visit BetterHelp.com/positive today to get 10% off your first month. That's BetterHelp, HELP.com/positive.
Shall I take your order, or do you need a minute?
Yes, I'll be ready. Just buying a car on Carvana.
What?
It's super convenient. I already got pre-qualified in 2 minutes. All I had to do was answer a few questions.
What? That's handy.
Yeah, now I'm customizing my down and monthly payments.
What? That's an exquisite deal.
And just like that, Carvana's delivering my car in a couple days.
What?
Oh, yeah. Sorry, I'll have the burrito.
Visit Carvana.com to finance your next car.
Financing subject to credit approval. Delivery fees may apply.
99.9 KISW. We return to the men's room with Miles and Thrill.
All right, so categories bite me on profile. This McDonald's restaurant was closed after a man ordered breakfast. Not sure what the item was, but he found something that was in the food. Now, keep in mind, there was a construction company that was doing business and doing work on that restaurant.
Yeah, and they had access to the kitchen. Yeah.
So that plays into this. So the question is, what was in his food? Was it a nail, a tape measure, a cigarette butt, or a crack pipe?
And that's the question that we put forward. Mike Hawk.
Ow!
You went with the tape measure, which lets
seems
make sense.
Kind of big, though.
It might, well, yep. It could fall off your belt, whatever the case might be. Miles, you went with the cigarette butt, which, let's face it, makes a lot of sense.
Okay, no.
And then finally, V. Ted Smith, you went with a
crack pipe.
Crack pipe, which in the world of construction also makes sense. And that
no
was
way.
They found the
no
pipe.
No way.
It was wrapped. It wasn't even in the sandwich. It was wrapped basically alongside it.
Oh, my goodness.
And dude's like, hey. Look, man, I can forgive a lot of things.
Well, you could use it as a straw for your orange
crack
juice.
Crack pipe rolled in with my sandwich. Like, figure it out.
Crack pipes are just so tiny, they could fall out of your pocket and end up anywhere.
Yeah, I guess. Man.
It doesn't sound to me like it was from the construction crew.
I don't know.
Sounds honestly, to me like it might be from the kitchen staff.
Man, I think that's flip a coin. McDonald's Third, kitchen
construction
staff.
Construction crews not wrapping sandwiches.
But if you're crackpot, come on.
Like, you know.
You would at least notice. Ooh, what's
if there was an earring in there, it fell out of the person who was constructing the sandwich. Not
right,
the other way around.
Not the crackpot.
Now for all TV news all the time, time for TV Time with Ted.
And now, because your pathetic life is confined to countless hours in front of a talking box, the Men's Room presents TV Time with Ted.
All right, your choices today. You got the Jimmys,
Fallon and Kimmel.
Seth Meyers, Colbert, or Ted Smith?
Is it Ted or is it Late Night?
It's right there in the title. Our guys have teams of talented writers and help them come up with their monologues each and every night. It is up to you to determine, is this an actual late night joke and from whom, or could it be a The Ted Smith original?
To help people keep their New Year's resolutions, a bar in the UK just renamed itself The Gym. So now people can go home and honestly say, I've gone to the gym every day this week. And if your partner believes this, I've got good news for you.
Kimmel.
Yeah, Seth.
Smith. Damn it. The gym.
Curveball in the first pitch.
<I know. laughs> Going to the gym, baby.
In a recent sermon, Pope Francis warned that pornography brings out, quote, satisfaction without relationship. That story again, the Pope is bad at warnings. Your warning against pornography shouldn't sound like a tagline for a porn site.
Seth Kimmel.
Seth!
In a recent sermon, Pope Francis warned that pornography brings, quote, satisfaction without relationship. That story again, the Pope is bad at warnings. Your warning against pornography shouldn't sound like the tagline for a porn site.
News from overseas. It's being reported that Vladimir Putin will soon visit North Korea. He better book his flight soon because once March hits, it's spring break central.
Fallon.
Kimmel.
Fallon.
Well, some news from overseas. I read that Vladimir Putin will soon visit North Korea. Well, we better book his flight soon, because once March hits, North Korea is spring break central.
We've heard about this one, but the makers of Kraft Singles have announced they will launch 3 new flavors for the first time in nearly 10 years, and hopefully one of them is cheese.
Seth?
Seth.
That's it.
The makers of Kraft Singles have announced that they will launch 3 new flavors for the first time in nearly 10 years, and hopefully one of them is cheese.
Right. I'll be honest with you, I didn't know Kraft ever had other flavors than the original single.
Mm-hmm. Before they release whatever they're about to release, do they?
I guess they.
I know they.
Everybody
mac and
keeps
cheese
saying
and
they had
that,
like 10 years ago. I mean, Kraft is a massive company,
that, right? Yep. But when
I
you
guess
say Kraft, singles,
I guess they've tried it before with the singles,
and it didn't take off.
Okay. Right. Right. Okay. And also, like. I've talked about it before. I love that show on History Channel, The Foods That Built America.
Mm-hmm.
So it's funny, when American cheese came around, Pabst Blue Ribbon actually had like the first, they came out at the same time. There was a lot of people, and it was cheese in a can that you could keep for a while, preferred Pabst. And then Kraft eventually got so tired of Pabst cutting into their cheese sales that I'm pretty sure they bought it.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay. All right.
Yeah.
Man, that's interesting. I should probably watch the show when I see it on my freaking info guide.
Sunday nights.
Is that their new... Jesus.
Yeah, and because okay. There's always, like... That one, I think it's run its course for the season. So there's other ones on there. But I even rewatched the one on fried chicken places the other day. And it's just kind of interesting. You know, you have the Colonel, but then you get Popeyes and this and that. What was his name?
Getting into the wing game after 51 years.
But yeah, usually Sunday nights. And then they have a couple of other shows like that. There's like... What is it, like the machines that built America?
Do they have toys or is that?
There is. Okay. There is a All toys right. that okay. built America
The one
as well.
That the lady and I were watching was the, what was it, the Booze, Bets, and Sex That Built America. That was a fun one.
That is a good one. Yeah.
About Jack Daniels and Marlboro and Trojan, I believe.
Oh, all the fun stuff.
Oh, exactly.
You are speaking exactly. my language.
And it's funny, too, when Marbles. You watch some of those historical shows, too, like you forget, like, when you have state lotteries and national lotteries, like, that was just the mafia running the numbers, and then the states were smart enough to go, wait a minute, they do this every day? People, like, my mom talks about, there was a guy that came by their house and knocked on the door, and her mom and father in the evening, or in the morning, would give them the numbers they wanted.
Wow. Huh? Wow.
And her mother, she played the numbers every day as long as she lived. All right, so there's a lot of reboots out there right now in the TV world. There's also been some planned reboots that are not going according to plan, like the Lizzie McGuire reboot starring Hilary Duff got canceled by Disney after filming two episodes.
Good. Damn.
So BuzzFeed put together a list of other planned TV reboots. They got reboots. They got feel Canadian when I say got canceled.
Has there been a good one? In other words, has there been one that came back where people said, like, with the Frasier one, they're kind of like, well, it's hit and miss, I guess. So is there one where people say, you know,
I mean, could you count the Connors in that?
I don't know.
I would count that in there.
You count that.
All right,
irony is that they got rid of Roseanne, who was the namesake of it, but they've done a good job because they just kind of pick up where they left off, right?
But typically back in the day, a reboot would be considered a spinoff. So Laverne and Shirley came from Happy Days.
Sure.
Like, there's always a...
Well, those are spinoffs. But it wasn't a reboot.
We're not taking the original cast, getting rid of all of them, and trying this whole thing again.
So it seems like, the formula is that you redo the show instead of spin off two popular characters or three and have a new direction to the show, which kind of used to be the thing back in the day.
I think there's still a lot of spinoffs, right? You look at The Walking Dead.
If you look at Yellowstone,
right? But also the reboots. Now, I honestly, there's just so many. There's so many streaming networks and everything. You have all that stuff, and then with the internet, there's so many people that go, "Oh, I love this and that." So I think that's why there's so many reboots right now. But there's still a lot of spinoffs.
Okay.
All right. So first on the list, number seven, there was the L.A. Law revival, Return of Blair Underwood.
I did not even know that happened.
Yeah.
I know he is. Oh, it didn't happen.
These are reboots. Planned reboots that got canceled. There was going to be a Charlie's Angels reboot called Angels 88, starring Tara Leone and Sandra Canning. That never got off the ground. That's a weird one, too.
I don't know if you could revive that based on socially where the country is now. Hey, ladies, don't wear bras, and you'd never see me, but go solve crime. I mean, that was actually the entire sales pitch of the show.
Charlie's Angels is a little tough, too, is right? You had the show, then what, three movies?
Yeah, dumbass movies, yeah, sure.
Like, you might have squeezed every little bit of juice out of that fruit.
Yeah, that fruit's dry, bro.
This one I would have watched, but it's not going to come to fruition. A reboot of Coach. With the return of Craig T. Nelson, set 18 years after the original series.
I would watch it if it's still Craig T. Nelson.
Yeah, he was supposed to come back.
Yeah. I find him very entertaining. He did so well with that.
It's just, where do you place him as far as being a coach?
Right.
Is it, what do I do with these kids?
Or bigger school?
Or is it like, I'm in a cul-de-sac and, you know.
I think it's 18 years later. And remember, he was the coach at fictional Minnesota State, I want to say. And they were never supposed to be very good. Then he got them good towards the end. I really loved Coach growing up.
I thought it was a great show, yeah.
So I bet nowadays he'd be in a smaller, like, Mountain West.
Something happened, okay.
Maybe he got to a big school.
Now he
ran to Alabama.
Single A high school.
Yeah. Also, it's funny. When I grew up, Craig T. Nelson, I knew him as Coach, right? Which is a very likable character and everything. And then... You know, you see these other movies. Like, I remember, was it Turner and Hooch? I think he's
a bad guy.
He's always a bad guy. It was like, it was crushing.
You can't wrap your head around it. Like, wait, but dude, he's Coach.
Yeah. I was so used to him being it's kind of the opposite. It's usually somebody plays a bad character, and it's hard to think of them as being nice.
I want to say, I'm not 100% on this, but I believe the cinematic masterpiece that was Action Jackson with our friend, Carl Weathers.
Mm-hmm.
Craig T. Nelson was a bad guy, where the greatest line in movie history in my mind went down, because you have to have a one-liner, and Carl Weathers has a flamethrower in his arms. This is clearly the end of the movie. You get your one-liner in, and all he said was, "How do you like your ribs?"
Sticky. Back in 07, they were going to relaunch The Simple Life, but instead of Paris Hilton and Nicole Richie would follow Kelly Osbourne and Kimberly Stewart. Kelly quit after filming the pilot in 2007 because she said it was demeaning to others.
Kelly Osbourne, well, that's not good. Whatever you think of her, is probably nine times smarter than Paris Hilton. And she'd already been kind of through the ringer with three other TV shows. So there's,
correct.
Right. She has a different view of what.
And they also Paris is smarter than she lets on.
No,
though.
Paris is much smarter than she lets on. What I'm saying the difference is for Kelly Osbourne is you're not launching my career. I've already done what Paris. So if you're going to relaunch this, I'm not here to act like an idiot. Unless I'm truly just being
in. You're also stepping into something that, you know, the Osbournes, and Ozzy said this, it was a reality show based on the fact that it was not scripted. It wasn't that they didn't lead you in a different direction.
Of course.
And all that stuff. But as far as the dialogue and the idea of what you're doing, they actually filmed them as a family in a home. Obviously, there's some Hollywood flash involved. But now you're putting someone in a situation where, like, okay, this is completely
right,
a setup.
Acted out.
This is total setup.
There was going to be a reboot of Clueless, which I love that movie. Dion Davenport was the main character instead of Cher, which I would watch that one because they were all pretty attractive. Reboots got canceled. A live action of Powerpuff Girls.
Good.
I'm happy to say I don't know a thing about Powerpuff Girls.
I watched
a cartoon.
I watched it a lot when I was a kid. It was a very fun show. It does not need a live action adaptation.
All right. Kind of like Disney.
I mean, exactly. Barbie's big enough that, like, people, you know about Barbie. You might know somebody that really watches Barbie, so you know more about the Barbie universe. But, like, everybody knows Barbie. But, like, Powerpuff Girls, I'm like,
I know what they look like.
I can pick them out.
And I think they already did reboot it or relaunch it, something like that. And it's fine. But, yeah, it does not need a live-action adaptation.
Here's the problem. When you're our age, it doesn't attract the six-year-old girl.
Right.
That was attracted to it the first time around.
Exactly.
You need something new to attract that younger generation.
There's one that's out right now, a Teen Titans Go. When I was a kid, there was a show called Teen Titans. It was a cartoon.
My kids loved
they
that
relaunched
show.
It to Teen Titans
Very
Go. Now,
funny,
my generation that watched Teen Titans absolutely livid about this reboot because they completely flipped it. Was yours serious?
Because the one I watched with my kids, it was so silly. So it's like SpongeBob.
Ours was like this gothic cartoon that was actually a very serious, very heavy cartoon. And then
I did not know that.
Then they got these Powerpuff Girl-esque superheroes on there for Teen Titans Go. And to their credit, the next generation loves it. My generation is salty because it's not for us anymore.
So I never watched Teen Titans, but I've watched episodes of Teen Titans Go. That's what I know. Like, sometimes I'll watch Cartoon Network Adult Swim.
Oh, yeah.
And then my sleep time, like, I'll fall asleep. And then, like, the next day, especially if it's a weekend, it's like, you turn on your TV and I'm like, oh, what's this cartoon?
Yeah, there were some heavy episodes in that first season. Yeah, the new one, the one that I know
to be true is not dark. By the way, real quick, Ted, text came and said, reboots include, and I didn't even think about this, Hawaii 5-0.
Well, sure.
MacGyver. Magnum P.I. I don't know if they're doing well.
Hawaii
right,
5-0
man.
Actually did really well.
It did.
Did it?
Yeah. We watched that one for a little while. It was a fun show.
Okay.
A reboot of Murder, She Wrote, starring Octavia Spencer.
Yeah.
So that one got canceled, too.
Maybe. I didn't love the show when it was on when I was younger, but Angela Lansbury was that character.
I feel like she is every character that she is.
You can like the show, you cannot like the show, but she was absolutely the character that drove that show, man. That's a tough ask.
Yeah, and again, I think that's when my mom loved Father Downey Mysteries, and I think Murder, She Wrote came on after that.
Yeah.
And I barely remember Kojak. I think I was always just jealous that he had a sucker in his mouth.
Charlie Zabalas.
Yeah, but like as a kid, it was just like, I don't know, it was cool, but I mean,
it was
like,
a blow pop. It was a real one, man.
Yeah, I didn't watch that much of it, but I clearly remember being old enough where it was like, my mother loved those Father Downey.
So did my mom.
Jane Seymour again.
Oh, she can be my medicine woman any day of the week. Let's see. Jeopardy, the second season finale of Celebrity Jeopardy. That's on tonight.
Let's go.
I'm cheering for Katie Nolan. I like sports. I like Katie Nolan. She's been dominating. I have not looked on the internet. I don't know what she does tonight, but I hope she does well.
Thank you, Tim. We appreciate it. You're listening to the Men's Room.
Okay, picture this. It's Friday afternoon when a thought hits you. I can spend another weekend doing the same old whatever, or I can hop into my all-new Hyundai Santa Fe and hit the road. With available H-Track all-wheel drive and three-row seating, my whole family can head deep into the wild. Conquer the weekend in the all-new Hyundai Santa Fe. Visit HyundaiUSA.com or call 562-314-4603 for more details. Hyundai, there's joy in every journey. 2024 Santa Fe, available early 2024.
Without the ones like you, who work tirelessly to keep things running, everything would suddenly stop. Hospitals, factories, schools, and power plants, they all depend on you. No matter the weather, emergency, or time of day, you're the ones who get it done. At Grainger, we're here for you with professional-grade industrial supplies. Count on real-time product availability and fast delivery. Call, clickgrainger.com or just stop by. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
At Metro by T-Mobile, there's not a yada yada. That means no contracts, no price hikes, and no surprises. We don't even hide what the lawyers make us say. We put it first. When we say no price hikes, we mean when you join Metro, your price will never increase for talk, text, and smartphone data. Our only exclusions are for limited time promos, for use charges, and third-party services. Nada yada, nada yada yada, nada yada. Nada yada yada means wireless without the gotcha. Only at Metro.
The Men's Room returns with Miles and Thrill. Now, let's see what's happening in the real world.
All right, here we go. A woman who is a huge hockey fan was found with 65 stolen Stanley Cups in the back of her car. We're in the Florida where a 20-year-old with a Camaro. He wants to one day be a NASCAR star. Man causes flight delay because he thought that a first-class ticket gets you extra seats for free. Police find drug suspect hiding at home. Good news. He was dry as can be. And cops ask a man for his ID. He accidentally hands him his meth. It's time for your headline.
Now, it's time to hit the head. Lines. Here's my car.
All right, our top story. We go to California where one woman reigns supreme in the latest fad. She was pursued by store employees after they saw her leaving with a cart full of merchandise that she hadn't paid for. She managed to get all the way to her car and stuffed the stolen goods inside before making her escape. She was eventually spotted by authorities out on the road and was arrested and charged with grand theft after stealing more than $2,500 worth of various Stanley drinking vessels.
What is it about these things that people are so excited about?
Honestly, I mean, think
is it a thermos?
It like just blew
hot,
up.
Hot, cold, cold.
I think it just kind of snowballed into being, you know, so great. Now, I think it is a good product. My wife has her Stanley,
sure.
And it is fantastic. It holds the temperature of the drink rather well. I think it's like a double wall insulation sort of a thing. You know, there's the advertisement that was basically done for them where a woman's car burnt up and the ice was still in her Stanley. Like, this thing holds temperature really,
video.
Really well.
Yeah, okay.
Not to mention the convenience of the handle. The straw has been a big thing here for a hot minute. It's the new hotness when it comes to drinking vessels, and I think it's blown up bigger than it should is the thing.
Because it's just a moment, right?
Because we have to go over the top with everything. And they're working with different kind of brands to create special edition Stanleys.
Right. That's okay. A big part of it. But like I said, like we were saying last week, like you'd recognize the traditional green Stanley with that metal
exactly.
Little cup on the top. So, I mean, sure. it's always been a good product.
But and yeah, it's found a way to really get into the pop culture mm-hmm. subconscious.
Yeah. And they gotten so popular, and you're right. I think working with the other brands definitely helps.
Absolutely. I mean, my wife wasn't going to get one until Lainey Wilson came out with one.
Yeah. Right? I even remember asking her, I was like, what is that cup?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, she's proud of that one, too. Only takes in certain places, so you're lucky, Ted.
I mean, look, that's one of those things. I don't get it, but also, like, hey, look, somebody's into it. I get it.
Exactly.
Go get them one.
Right. At some point, you go, I don't need to understand.
Right.
Have fun. It's what it makes you happy. Cool. In other news to Florida, where a genius managed to dime himself out, an officer out on patrol noticed a truck whose tailgate was obstructing his license plate, so he decided to pull the driver over. The stop was just routine when the officer asked for the driver's license, which he handed over without incident, but the officer noticed something. A crystalline substance that was on the license. It was mm-hmm. tested and came back positive for methamphetamine. A canine unit was then deployed, which indicated that there were indeed more drugs in the car, despite the driver having no knowledge as to where the substance could have come from.
I don't know.
The drugs were indeed found in the car along with more, and the driver is now facing charges.
Dude, look, I like drugs.
Don't cut it with your license.
Do not cut it with your license. Do not cut it with the credit card that you use. Like, I don't know, man, take the Joker card from your deck of cards. Don't do it with something.
Why am I a better druggie than you?
Man, I got years of experience. That's one. Two, like, the cops don't want to deal with you.
Right.
You're making it a problem, and you're like, oh, dude, I cut this with meth. Even the cop's like, man, I know you're on meth, but now I know for a fact you're on meth.
Yeah.
I have to do paperwork.
Exactly.
Just be methy and get home.
Just get home, man.
They don't go home. That's the issue.
We can't make it easier for you. We don't care what you do unless you make it obvious.
Exactly. Let's go to Louisiana.
You can find it almost the same corner. Cokeheads probably hanging out at the party still.
Sure.
Those meth heads, man, they don't go home. They just wander.
That's right. Like zombies. Let's go to Louisiana, where another man got a visit from police for drugs. Officers arrived at what they believed to be the man's residence to bring him in on possession for charges of for crack. They were met by his girlfriend, who repeatedly screamed at officers that he was not in the building, as well as another young gentleman that caused a commotion regarding the validity of a search warrant that the officers presented. Both accomplices were arrested on their own charges of obstruction, side note. But the search of the house turned up empty due to the home being rather small and low on potential hiding places. However, sharp-thinking officers eventually made their way to the kitchen, where movement was detected in the dryer.
Don't move!
They eventually found their man and brought him in. I know.
Jeez. Man, and look, I'm not trying to encourage criminals to be criminal. It's not that. But if you are a criminal, I accept that that's part of human nature.
Right.
But don't...
This is part of the gig, too. If you're going to hide from cops, be good at it.
Right. Don't embarrass the rest of us by being that stupid.
Right.
I mean,
man, it's uncomfortable in this dryer.
Yeah, I mean, shut up!
Getting a Charlie horse.
Deal with it, druggie. Over to China, where three... Over to China, where 300 passengers met their nightmare. I would have beat this man unmerciful. A man in first class caused a commotion when he attempted to give himself a bonus first class ticket. You see, he had bought two first class seats and one economy seat, believing himself entitled to a third first class seat for his family to all sit together.
But you just said it.
Because, you know, he bought two.
And then a third economy. That's right. Like it says it.
Despite having airline policy explained several times, the man stood firm, insisting that he deserved this first class seat. For 3 hours, he insisted that he deserved it. And he was eventually escorted off the plane by authorities. Jesus. The 300 people on that flight had to make different arrangements for their connections.
Because
this Jamoke...
Now, as the airline industry, right, we accept how terrible you are.
Right.
Doing things on time or oversold. Can we have a thing where, all right, we are now locked and loaded. We're ready to fly.
Right.
This passenger, and we're going to tell you the reasons, they feel justified in saying this. So we will explain it over the intercom. If we have a problem, can we, as customers, deal with them?
Right.
You will not delay my flight.
And don't worry, he'll make it to the destination. He's just going to be riding outside of the plane all the way there.
I don't know if to beat your ass.
Duct tape his ass to the wing.
But you will be physically removed from this plane. Mm-hmm. I got things to do. That's all.
And just in case those stories left a bad taste in your mouth,
thankfully, there's good news.
A Jewish congregation, nice. A Jewish congregation in New York has submitted a record-breaking feat to Guinness. Working with a local bakery and using 200 pounds of dough and a 40-foot tunnel oven, the committee managed to make a 35-foot long loaf of challah bread. The current record is 32-foot loaf from Sydney, and that's still under...
That stuff is delicious.
I've never tried to do it, but the loaf that they made looks fantastic.
I mean, it's a sweet bread.
It's braided bread.
It's braided sweet bread, right?
Oh, God, dude, awesome. That's so good.
I'm in.
Yes.
Let's go. In the world of sports, you got college hoops over on the ESPN channels as well as CBS Sports and basketball on TNT. And you've also got the Trailblazers over on Route taking on the Thunder. As far as your weather tonight, cooling down to low 40s tonight, and the rain is back for tomorrow. Looking at consistent rain and high 40-degree temperatures, so bundle up and get a jacket on. That's it for your headlines with that. Mike Hawk is out.
Thank you, sir. We appreciate it. We'll see you next time for the return of Who Sucks Less, the man with the blue eyes who pierces you on social media. Kevin Deers
is
yes,
up next.
Indeed, it is so true. But in the meantime, well, we be on about this bitch for 180 seconds or so. So until then, please do what you do best. And for Aletha's sake, stay beautiful.
This room has been taped before a live studio audience. Wardrobe and makeup provided by Mantastic Limited. This has been a presentation of the Men's Room Radio Network.
Oh, man.
A Double Flush production.
Maximize the compensation for your injury claim with Phillips Law Firm. With over 80 years of combined legal experience, they won't allow the insurance companies to dictate what's good enough for you. Whether it's an auto accident or workplace injury, contact Phillips Law Firm today. If they don't win, you don't pay.
Okay, picture this. It's Friday afternoon when a thought hits you.
I can spend another weekend doing the same old whatever, or I can hop into my all-new Hyundai Santa Fe and hit the road. With available H-Track all-wheel drive and three-row seating, my whole family can head deep into the wild. Conquer the weekend in the all-new Hyundai Santa Fe. Visit HyundaiUSA.com or call 562-314-4603 for more details. Hyundai, there's joy in every journey. 2024 Santa Fe, available early 2024.
Do relationships have to be easy to be right? Of course not. The best relationships with friends, family, or partners happen when both people put in the time and commitment to make them great. Therapy can help. BetterHelp offers convenient, affordable online therapy. Start the process in minutes and switch therapists anytime. Give your relationship some love with BetterHelp. Visit BetterHelp.com/positive today to get 10% off your first month. That's BetterHelp, HELP.com/positive.
Get ahead of postage rate increases this year with Stamps.com. It's like your own personal post office. Sign up with promo code PROGRAM for a 4-week trial plus free postage and a free digital scale. No long-term commitments or contracts. That's Stamps.com code PROGRAM.